Unicorns, and welcome back to my channel. If this is indeed the first time that you're on my channel, please allow for me to introduce myself to you. My name is Vanessa Semina. I am the proud author of two tarot decks, and of course, your favorite psychic here on YouTube. And for today's ultra-personalized two-part pick-a-card reading, I have a highly anticipated topic prepared for you. Today's reading is all about your personal love story. You heard me right, my beautiful unicorn family. We are going to be sipping some boiling hot tea with one another. And it's going to entail all the personal details of your love story. And my mango peach tea is hitting all the right spots for this reading. I recommend that you get yourself a beverage of your choice as well and simply enjoy. So for part one of your personal love story reading, you get to choose from these four groups, which I am about to introduce you to. And once you have received part one of your reading, which is more about the general dynamic of your relationship, how you'll meet this person, and the length of the relationship, you then get to scroll back down into the description box or the top of the comment section where I have timestamps provided for all 12 signs of the zodiac. So in order to receive your second and even more personalized part of your prediction, simply click the timestamp of your zodiac sign after you've received the first part of your reading. And by combining these two parts with one another, you receive your very own highly personalized love story prediction. So now that you know how your updated love story prediction works, allow me to introduce you to the four groups that I have available for you today. Group number one corresponds to the Pink Pain Tarot deck as well as the Carnelian Crystal and the following sound. Group number two corresponds to the Shamanic Medicine Oracle deck as well as the Rose Quartz Crystal and the following sound. Group number three corresponds to the Divine Feather Messenger Oracle deck, the Sodalite Crystal, as well as the following sound. And group number four corresponds to the Tarot of the Divine, the Citrine Crystal, and the following sound. As already mentioned, the timestamps to all four of these groups can be found down below in the description box and pinned to the top of the comment section for quick and easy access. So I will now provide you with a little moment of privacy so you can meditate on these four groups. Feel free to pause the video right here if you need a little bit more time in order to make up your mind as to which group you'd like to choose. So I'll be back with you momentarily in order to guide you through your love story readings. So by now, you've hopefully been able to select one of these four groups in order to receive the first part of your prediction. I will be starting off with the first group, which corresponds to the Pink Pain Tarot deck, as well as the Carnelian Crystal. So if this is the group that you chose, please continue watching. And to all of my other lovely groups and signs of the zodiac, I'll catch you at the click of your timestamp. Hello, group number one, and welcome to your love story reading. You chose the Pink Pain Tarot deck in connectivity to the Carnelian Crystal in order to help guide you through your love story prediction. So this is the beautiful Carnelian Crystal. Up close, this is an absolutely stunning stone that brings a lot of creativity as well as passion, which may already be a bit of an indicator as to what your love life will look like. But let's move into the cards so we can figure out exactly what's coming towards you romantically speaking. So we've got the Moon, the Seven of Pills, as well as the Judgment card. So group number one, in the Moon, first and foremost, I can see that you will intuitively know when you're with the right person. Group one, if you're still asking yourself whether someone who you're seeing is the right person for you or not, stop right there. They are not the one who we are talking about within this love story reading, because you will intuitively know that you're with the one Well, when you're with them or when you've met them. I see here within the Seven of Pills that it's definitely going to be a relationship that allows for both of you to grow and allows for the two of you to see the world from a completely different viewpoint and angle. I see that here in connectivity to the Judgment card. Now, the Seven of Pills and the Judgment card does also show me that you're at a point where you and the person with whom your love story is supposed to play out with, you've already done a lot of growing. So you've maybe individually already gone to therapy, you've journaled, you're doing some meditating, just overall, self-development is a big topic for both of you. And you both know of the importance of continuing to grow as a human being and also to continue on the self-developmental journey. I see here within the Magician that your love story is playing out with someone who is confident, sophisticated, a leader, and they're the type of person who definitely stands out in a crowd. They don't go unnoticed and they don't mind it at all. They're a bit more eccentric and artistic, and just overall here within the Magician, I can see that they're a jack of all trades. They're not the type of person that you can just place into a box. Next up, we've got the Six of Pills. The Six of Pills shows me that we've got some family situations happening here, and by family situations, I mean your love story actually playing out with you having your own family, with you being in a committed relationship where family is a big topic and something that you are slowly but surely growing into. As I see here with the Seven of Pills, you're not quite there yet, but your love story is of course meant to develop over time, over years and decades. So do know here that you may change your mind about what your family structure should look like in the end. If you don't want children at all right now, or you're not really thinking about adding to your family, whether it be human babies or animal babies, never say never is the catchphrase of your love story group number one, because there will be some very big unexpected changes coming towards you, romantically speaking, that, you know, as mentioned, you just didn't anticipate at all. Don't forget that in part two of your reading, we'll be going into a few more details, such as letters in their name and so on. So do make sure that you hold tight here when it comes to your love story prediction and you receive that second part of your reading as well. Within the Wind Chimes, I can see that your love story is supposed to be one that is peaceful, that is harmonious. You're not meant to be in a toxic or drama-filled relationship whatsoever. I see here within the Wind Chimes that you really do thrive the most with someone who gives you stability and of course provides you with excitement, but not the type of excitement that translates into anger or worrying about what they're doing at any given point in time. I see here within the Wind Chimes that your relationship and your love life is going to be a peaceful and harmonious one. The Ink Pot shows me that problem solving is something that you're both really good at. You're going to be with someone who is mature, as the Ink Pot shows me here, that problems will be resolved in a peaceful manner, in a mature manner, without just blaming one another or constantly rehashing the same point of friction and contention over and over again. Quite the opposite is true for you, group number one, as I can see here within the Ink Pot, that whenever there's friction or issues, you're able to resolve these with the love of your life. And why I'm saying the love of your life is because, well, in the Moon, you intuitively know that they're the right one, and they are opening you to seeing things from a bigger perspective. The Wind Chimes in the Ink Pot shows me here that this is a relationship that is not going to crack under pressure. So therefore, we have a relationship here that has that soulmate and twin flame potential that shows that you may be together for the entirety of your existence here on this earthly plane. So your relationship definitely has the potential to last forever, group number one, and I can definitely see two very caring and loving people with one another who just want the best for everyone involved, whether it is the two of you or any additional family members that you've added into the relationship. Next up, we've got the Temperance card. In the Temperance card, I can see here that your love story is all about moderation. It's all about doing a little bit of everything and experiencing lots of different angles and lots of situations in life with one another. So traveling, doing things professionally with one another, never kind of being set in stone about anything, as I see here within the Magician, the Judgment, and the Temperance card, that we have a lot of flexibility here, and that you as a whole, as a couple, are never going to rule anything out from one another. So you're not going to rule out ever working together or starting your own business with one another. You're not completely going to rule out a family structure that maybe now seems far-fetched, but in the future you may change your mind. It's just all about accepting the fact that while right now in the moment your relationship may not be able to accommodate the things that are still coming for you in the future, but that doesn't mean that it's never going to happen. So you really do have very mature energy here with your partner. Next up, we've got the Knight of Swords. So in connectivity to how you're going to meet this person and the length of the relationship, know here in the Knight of Swords that you're going to meet them in a type of whirlwind romance situation. And it's going to feel like everything's moving very quickly, but because you're excellent communicators, as here in the Knight of Swords, we have that confirmed in this air sign, and air signs are all about communication. Yes, the Knight of Swords may still have a little bit of communication skills that they can learn or brush up on. Group number one, I want you to know here in the Knight of Swords that nevertheless, they are trying their best, and you see that they're putting in that effort, and that's something you can work with, and you're happily doing so, as I can see that the Knight of Swords is like the start of your relationship. You're going to meet them by communicating, by being honest, by also maybe having a little bit of friction in the relationship due to that brutal honesty. But that is also what makes your relationship thrive and so special, because you're not keeping any secrets from one another. Next up, in the Six of Crystals, I see that this is a very victorious approach for you, and you're slowly but surely going to learn to handle one another's communication styles and skills, and you're going to learn to communicate with one another in a way that isn't hurtful, if you know what I mean. So being brutally honest can sometimes hurt the other person's feelings and emotions, but the Six of Crystals definitely shows me here that you will be triumphant during your love story and in finding a way of practicing a non-violent communication, and that is what will ultimately allow for this relationship to thrive. The Eight of Cups shows me that the art of letting go is a big part of your love story, group number one. If right now you're the type of person who doesn't really like to let things go, especially if you've been hurt or if you're unsure about a situation and you just want that 100% Windex type of clarity, do know here that you will learn to let things go more and more, especially the battles that aren't really worth fighting, group number one, because they exist. You can still have a very honest and transparent relationship while letting certain things go that really just are not worth the hassle. So I see that in your love story, you are maturing with the person who you're meant to be with, and you're both growing simultaneously. You both want the same things out of the relationship and out of life. The Octopus shows me practicing shape-shifting by altering your physical appearance and mannerisms. Oh, that's a big one. You sure do know how to put on a very professional kind of front with the person with whom you're going to be with, group number one. And by professional front, I mean you know how to communicate in certain situations that require professionalism or you seeming to be more serious, okay? So if you're invited to a business dinner or some sort of event, you know exactly what to wear, how to conduct yourself, how to speak in a manner that allows for people to remember the two of you as a very eloquent couple. And at the same time, when it is the time to have fun, to let loose, to just celebrate and be silly with one another, you can do that too. The octopus is a highly intelligent animal and being, so I want you to know here that this definitely shows that your relationship is very flexible, your love story is adaptable, and that's also why it is going to persist and last for such a long time, for potentially your entire life. Next up, we've got the Kiwi. Doing walking meditations each day for the next week is going to help you clear your mind, but it's also something you're going to find that you incorporate with your partner, with your forever person, walking together, going on strolls, and just allowing for your minds to clear without even needing to talk to one another. You don't always need to be saying things in order to get along with one another or know that the other person is in a good mood or a sad mood. You understand one another just silently. You don't need to always verbally communicate. You can read your person's energy and they can do the same for you, group number one, which is another reason why you work so beautifully with this person, because you don't even need to say a word to feel comfortable around them or to know what the other person is going through and feeling. And sometimes you just need someone to be silent but still there for you, if you know what I mean. Like, you need someone physically there, but not for them to say anything, just to be quiet, as we have here in the Four of Swords. Your relationship works so well because your person isn't always trying to jump to fix things or give you advice. They're really great at just listening. And that's part of your love story, and that's part of what makes your relationship so successful and what allows you to feel like you've really found someone who gets you and gets your core. We've got the King of Cups, which is an indication of this person, their mannerisms, and their character. So in the King of Cups, we have someone who is super caring and nurturing. They are the type of person who, emotionally speaking, is highly intelligent. They can get in their feels, but at the same time, they're pretty mature about it. They're not just going to get in their feels and kind of make you suffer all day if you did something that upset them. They are definitely a very open type of person. They will let you know if something needs to be done in order to rectify hurt feelings, which again is a big reason why communication works so effortlessly and beautifully with your person, group number one. So this is part one of your love story. I hope that you've enjoyed it so far. But now don't forget to scroll down into the description box, click your zodiac sign, and be fast forwarded to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction in order to receive details such as letters in their name, their signs, some chart placements, whatever we have coming through, such as their job, their profession. So make sure that you check that out, group number one. Click your zodiac sign, and I'll catch you during part two of your highly personalized love story. Hello, group number two, and welcome to the first part of your love story prediction. You chose the Shamanic Medicine Oracle deck in connectivity to the Rose Quartz Crystal. Let's first do a little close-up on your stone. This is the Rose Quartz Crystal. This is the stone of love and friendship and just unconditional empathy. Let's move into your reading so we can figure out exactly what your love story is going to be and how your romantic life will play out, group number two. We've got the Middle World, we've got the Offerings, as well as the Trickster. So this is a very interesting start to your love story prediction. Allow me to explain to you exactly why that is, group two. In the Offerings, I can see that your love story is going to come with a lot of wealth, and this type of generational wealth is one that not everybody gets to experience, but you are definitely in a fortunate position where material wealth is provided, romantically speaking. I see here within the Middle World that right now it is very important for you to ensure that you're staying in the moment, that you're not overthinking the future and whether you're going to fit in with someone who comes from a very wealthy background, who comes from a lot of fortune. So I do also want you to understand here within the Trickster that there are some people out here who are posing to be wealthy, who are proposing to come from this background of a lot of affluence, and it is important for you to weed those people out who are trying to pretend to be something that they're not. Not just because group number two, you are only going for someone who does come from material wealth, but because it is so important for you to be with someone who's comfortable in their own skin, whether they have a lot of material possessions, whether they have a lot of financial security or not. The foundation of a relationship, after all, is trust. And it's important for your love life for you to be able to trust that what someone is saying and portraying is true. So ultimately, I can definitely see your love life moving into a space where you're with someone who is rather well off. Next up, we've got bones for casting. In bones for casting, I see that divination is a very strong and very telling point in your love life, group number two. So just overall divination, which means oracle cards, tarot cards, different forms of using the divine, of using these sacred messages in order to figure out what your future holds. These are all very detailed as well as accurate ways for you to find out what comes next when it comes to your love life. So don't take these pieces and bits of information lightly, as they are very accurate for your situation specifically. Next up, we've got the Two of Swords. The Two of Swords shows me here that your love story is all about making the right choices based on your gut feeling and your intuition, not overthinking things and not reading too much into situations. If you already have a feeling, like here with the trickster, that someone maybe isn't honest with you when you're dating or starting to build a bit more of a romantic life, try to steer clear of that type of person and to not even give them the time of the day, really, because at the end of the day, you have to be a little cutthroat and very direct and honest with yourself. If you feel as though someone is using you, not telling the truth, or playing with your feelings and wasting your time, you're most likely right about that, group number two. Don't try to explain the red flags away. Simply acknowledge them and know that there are so many more fish in the sea for you. You don't have to put up with any type of treatment that you're not happy with. Of course, that will require strength. So I see that your love story is definitely one of personal growth and strength and development in those areas of your personality and character, group two. So while this is a quote unquote rocky road, or not the smoothest road, at the end of the day, this is a road that will lead you ultimately to a lot of happiness. And as already mentioned, financial and material security, which means that you will have more time to enjoy and experience other things in life rather than worrying about your financial security. Next up, we've got justice. So for justice, I can see here that you're most likely going to meet this person with whom your love story is going to play out in a place where people seek balance. So think, for example, a courtroom, a court office type of thing. I can see that the person with whom you're meant to be with has a lot of power and a very high social standpoint. I can definitely see that in the socioeconomic hierarchy, they're the type of person that a lot of people look up to and respect. So they may be a judge or just overall be in charge of a lot of big decisions. And you're going to meet them during a time where those big decisions are coming into effect or being made. I see here within the Three of Pentacles that it's going to start off more like a work collaboration. So you will meet this person while you're doing some sort of project that you're into professionally speaking. So you're not going to meet them, say, on a night out or anything like that. It is because you have very similar professional interests and fields, and you're going to meet them while you're pursuing more of your own growth, professionally speaking, when it comes to your job. In the Nine of Wands, I can see that they're very tired, okay? They are tired of the relationships that they've been in. I can see that your love story is going to work out so beautifully because the person who you'll end up with wants to settle down and have a real relationship. They don't want to continue to hem and haw about whether someone is the right one or not. They are done with quick relationships with affairs and anything of that nature. They want to settle down with one person. Let's see what card is so temperamental in your reading. We've got the Platypus. The Platypus is all about ceasing to complain and focusing your attention on the blessings in your life. And connecting that to the middle world, I can see that for you, group number two, your guides and the spirits are giving you a little bit of tough love right now because they're telling you to stop complaining immediately, to try to turn everything into a learning lesson, and even when you're going through a tough time, asking yourself, what is this situation trying to teach me? What is this situation trying to offer to me? So we also have that here within the offerings. And connecting that to the trickster, reminding yourself here, the challenges are often here in order to really show you how you've grown when it comes to your character, when it comes to your personality, and to show just how strong that you can be and how far you've come to the point where no matter what type of challenges you may face, you know that in the end, everything's going to be fine. And sometimes these challenges are just here in order to help you grow and shape you into the person who is deserving of someone like this lover that we have for your love story, and vice versa, right? They've been through tough times too, even though they're maybe from an affluent background or family, and they have a life that is pretty secure financially. That doesn't mean that they've had their own trials and tribulations that they've had to learn from and overcome. The Roadrunner is all about keeping your sense of humor and not taking anything too seriously. Now, if you're a bit of a worrywart, group number two, this may be hard for you, but thank God your love story entails someone who first and foremost really makes you laugh, has an amazing, healthy sense of humor, and is the type of person with whom you can just spend hours and hours listening to and telling stories to one another, laughing about moments that were embarrassing or difficult, and finding humor in a lot of situations that other people would find maybe hard to swallow or hard to deal with, but you both always tend to see the positives and the glass as half full. Next up, we've got the Tower reversed. You're building with this person. So your love story is all about building from the ground up. I can definitely see that, you know, we've got the Tower reversed. We're upright. This would be a situation of destruction. This would mean that the relationship, your love story, actually has a little bit of a fatal end or streak to it. But because we had the Tower reversed for you, group number two, I do want you to understand here that you are building your own existence and your own identity with your lover, with whom you're meant to be with. And I can see that your love story is all about empowering yourself, the person who you're with, and building your own empire, also independently from maybe the family wealth that they come from. So this is a really great sign when it comes to a long-term relationship. The High Priestess shows me that you are completely aligned in your love story when it comes to religion or any type of core beliefs, any type of moral questions. You and the person with whom you're meant to be with, you're on the same page. You definitely have a very similar outlook and worldview. You feel the same way about political questions, and I definitely see in the High Priestess that that is something that you can talk to your person about in a very lighthearted way, and you never feel as though there's pressure. You feel as though you can always bring humor into your conversations and situations. We've got the Two of Swords next. We already had the Two of Swords show up for the first time here within the Pastel Journey. We spoke about you being intuitive, and we have that represented again in the Two of Swords here, where it seems as though your eyes are blindfolded, right? Which means that you cannot just sit there and wait until the route or the path is illuminated and completely clear to you. You have to make decisions beforehand, before you can see and know whether you have in fact made the right choice. And that is where your instinct and intuition, as we have represented here within the crescent moon symbol, comes into play, and listening to that, not taking it for granted, and in fact taking your gut feeling, your gut instinct very seriously. A lot of animals and Also, human beings in some more remote areas of the world still rely on this, and we have for a very long time. So I definitely feel like we need to put some more respect on instinct and intuition's name. In the Four of Pills, I can see stability here financially, right? The number four, as well as the Suit of Pills, which corresponds to the element of earth, that stands for everything material, everything that is also kind of finite, okay? Your time, your financial resources. I see in the Four of Pills that we've got this stability and that your person wants to share that with you. They're done with people who have been using them just for financial gain or a type of status elevation. The Seven of Bottles shows me here that your romantic life, your love story, is all about finally finding someone who loves you for you and also for your person. You love them for them, not because of all the things that they can offer you. Of course, they're really nice, but they are not what make this relationship work, and your person can feel that. Your love story is based on real deep love, not the superficial kind. And you, as well as your lover, will be feeling that day in and day out. The Five of Pills does show me here that they almost do a little too much for you. So I can see here that one point of contention is definitely who makes the majority of the income. I see in the Five of Pills that they most likely want you to have more of an easy life and existence, but you still want your independence. And those are just areas of contention where you're going to have to find a middle ground, because I totally get you, group number two, why you don't want to be financially dependent on your lover. We've got the Justice card again, which just definitely shows that the universe is trying to reiterate certain parts of your reading. We've had the Two of Swords show up twice for you already. Now we have the Justice card here as well as over here, which actually connects to the number 11, which is a master number. If that is your life path number, or the number 11 has a very symbolic type of significance to you, do know here that it's speaking directly to you via this Justice card, telling you how important it is for you to keep your freedom, okay, keep your independence, and it's not too much for you to ask. Sometimes you simply have to break through some ego from your partner, from the person with whom you're meant to be with. In the Ten of Cigarettes, I can see that they're going to give it up not too long thereafter, so they may at first kind of want to care for you and coddle you and take you away from any type of difficult situation, okay? They want to shelter you to a degree that is kind of too much for you, group number two, and you understand that it's just coming from a kind place, but at the same time, I see here in the Ten of Cigarettes, the Justice card, and the Five of Pills that you still want your own thing. You still want to feel like you're contributing to the relationship, and that is something that you will be able to do after some discussion. So this is not a bad thing, group number two. I just want to be very honest with you about your love story and the areas that are working beautifully and the areas where you will have a little bit of friction or some disagreements. That way you can prepare yourself and you also kind of already know what's coming towards you. It's important for me to be transparent with you on not just the beautiful things, but also the things that could end up being a bit challenging. So group two, this is the first part of your reading that I received for you. Leave a lion emoji down below in the comment section if you picked group two and you made it to the end, but don't forget to click your zodiac sign so you'll be fast forwarded to part two of your love life prediction, where I go into a lot more details, such as letters in their name. We will go into birth chart placements if the universe provides those, and just a lot more nitty gritty little stuff that will allow you to truly know with whom your love story is going to play out. So group two, this is the reading that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful, and I'll catch you during the second and even more a personalized part of your love story prediction. Hello, group number three, and welcome to the first part of your love story prediction. You chose the Divine Feather Messenger Oracle deck as well as the Sodalite Crystal. Let's do a quick close-up on the crystal of your choice. This is the beautiful Sodalite. I absolutely love its structure. This is a stone that helps bring out courage, but at the same time, it keeps you very grounded and calm. So if you're looking for a stone with those qualities, then you know exactly which one to go for. You also felt drawn to the peacock feather. So the peacock feather reveals to us an inherent wisdom that's emerging at this time from you, Group 3. Watch it and ready yourself for a rebirth, as I can see that when it comes to your love story prediction, everything is going to change. So if you think to yourself right now what your ideal love story looks like, know here, Group number 3, that you should best prepare yourself for something completely different, because you will go through a rebirth personally, but also in your romantic life and that dynamic. Next up, we've got the woodpecker. The woodpecker stands for using your discernment and fortitude to achieve your goals and find a new rhythm. So knowing here that overall things are going to change, the dynamics, the rhythms that would usually accompany your romantic relationships, whether it be the frequency at which you text another person or meeting another person, it's going to completely change. If you're barely seeing romantic partners now, maybe only on the weekends, know that that dynamic is going to change, and maybe you'll move in with them and see them every single day. The same goes for you finding a new rhythm in the relationship when it comes to finances. If it's usually just split down the middle, know that it's going to change to be a bit more one-sided, and just overall, there will be a complete shift in how you see your relationship growing and evolving, and just overall how your love story plays out. Let's figure out more details. I see here within support that your life purpose fully supports you, and that your love story is going to play out with someone who supports you just as much as your life purpose and the universe. So no more people who are maybe insecure and let out their feelings of insecurity on you, or who have any problems with their ego that doesn't really allow them to be open and vulnerable. I can also see that you've got a big career change ahead of you, and you're embarking upon a career that brings you the joy and the abundance that you desire and deserve. So it is really important for you to not be with someone who is jealous or who feels threatened by your success or your career change, because that will of course just lead to a lot of destruction, hurt, pain, and anger and resentment within a relationship. So avoiding that at all costs is what I can see here. The King of Diamonds shows me that you will end up with someone who has a strong earth sign energy. So think Taurus, Virgo, but also Capricorn. They are most likely older, more mature than you, as the King of Diamonds suggests. They have their own thing going on. They have no reason to feel emasculated or feel as though their femininity is being snatched from them. However it is that they identify, you get the idea, Group number 3, they don't feel as though your success takes away from them whatsoever. The King of Diamonds shows me that they come from their own background of fortune. They come from a background of hard work. They're proud of their achievements, and they have absolutely no reason to feel threatened by you, because they have their stuff going on, which allows for them to be your biggest cheerleader. Next up, we've got the Nine of Diamonds. The Nine of Diamonds shows me here that they've basically accomplished everything that they've wanted to accomplish in the earthly realms at this point. So they've made the type of money that they wanted to make. They have the type of car or home or lifestyle that they've always dreamed of. And now for your person, the last missing piece of completion is really just a relationship and a lover who respects them for who they are and wants to now build something more meaningful with them, something that has absolutely nothing to do with just financial gain and everything to do with health, both physically, mentally, and just overall well-being and family. The Three of Cups shows me that there's reason for celebration. So your love story is going to come with a lot of really important pivotal moments where you're celebrating with people who have supported you ever since the beginning of this love story. So a big indication about whether you're with the right person or not is that a lot of people will support your relationship right from the get-go, and they will be celebrating celebrating your relationship in many different ways. The Emperor shows me here that your relationship is the first of its kind in your lineage, in your family. So maybe it is because of your romantic orientation, the type of person who you like to be with, their gender. Maybe it's also that you guys are the first ones to actually be in a healthy, long-lasting relationship within your lineage. And that is something that, sure, some people are jealous of, but most people are actually celebrating, and you will reach a lot of milestones with this person. So think to yourself starting a family of your own, accomplishing some great things professionally speaking, getting that public recognition. And I want you to know here within counseling that you're the type of person who heals with kind words, wise advice, and an empathetic ear. And this is something that your person really appreciates, and this is why your love story works for you, group number three. Because you're a very empathetic person, you're non-judgmental, and you always have an open ear no matter the situation. I see here within infinite abundance, we already kind of spoke about that within the King of Diamonds, that your person has their own thing going on. They have no reason to feel jealous of you financially or with their career. I see that you're fully supported as you devote yourself to your divine life purpose. So it's like we have this double income here where you're making a lot of money, they're making a lot of money, no one is jealous of one another, and you're just in full support and you're leveling one another up, okay? You're not in a situation where one of you has a bruised ego because the other one is very successful. No, it's not like that at all. You're all about that infinite abundance. You're all about building together. You're all about creating generational wealth and understanding that if you can both do really well professionally and financially, why not? That doesn't take away from the other person's success at all. That actually just adds to the relationship. I can see here within death that your love story is definitely also going to outlive certain relationships around you. So marriages or other relationships that seem very fixed right now are actually going to be the complete opposite, okay? Your relationship and your love story will outlive the love story of many of those surrounding you. Also, love stories that start after yours. So people are going to get married and divorced during the time that your love story plays out. And I can definitely also see here within death that you're both going to outlive many friends and family members, group number three, just to be transparent and honest with you. And you're going to be there to support one another. And it's definitely going to be a big change in dynamic whenever your surrounding changes, be it either because a relationship around you breaks up or people go through a divorce, but you guys are like the rock. Your relationship is really like the one constant that stays together really until death does you apart with your partner. So I can see that your love story is definitely meant to be one that plays out over a lifetime and where you're with someone for a very, very long time. It's not a quick fling situation. Next up, we've got the Lodge. So the Lodge shows me that you actually provide shelter and support to other people. So your love story is going to be one that is laced with a lot of philanthropy. So you and your partner, you and your person are going to be helping others, giving them advice, taking them in, and just overall making sure that you're providing value to the world. I see here within the East that you both will notice that your heart is definitely in these causes a lot more than it maybe is in material gain. So through your career change and just overall the relationship dynamic is definitely a fortunate one when it comes to finances. But you will find that where you are truly passionate and what truly brings you joy that money is never able to match is because you are able to give back to others. That's where you really light up and where you find that money can, in a sense, buy happiness because you don't have to spend time worrying about how you're going to pay your bills. So being financially fortunate is definitely a stepping stone to happiness, but it isn't quite the core or the center of why you're in a happy place. So next up, we've got the cave. In the cave, I can see here that your love story is going to have some phases where you definitely want to retreat and be alone and just spend a little bit of time growing independently. And this is one thing that is provided and given within your relationship. I see here within death as well as counseling that you and your partner within your love story, you believe in growth and allowing for one another to grow in different directions, allowing for one another to go through different phases and for death and life to happen constantly. So maybe for some reason you're obsessed with a certain topic for a few months and then you move on to the next, right? You experience the death of your obsession with cooking certain types of meals or going on hikes or maybe trying to plan different trips to certain areas of the country, and all of a sudden you move to a different obsession, you move to a different type of show or way of being that interests you more, that you want to explore further, group number three, and you're fully supported in that, and you're not kept in a box where your partner is constantly telling you that you're being inauthentic just because you thrive being flexible and allowing for change to be part of your life. I see here in the Queen of Crystals that you're also a very creative type of passionate person. I can see that your love life, well, your intimate life, is one of communication and is definitely going to be very different from anything you've experienced in the past. The Seven of Diamonds shows me that a big part of your love life working out well for you is because you're open to trying things, to maybe bringing little accessories into your private moments, if you know what I mean, group number three, and you're just overall a very open-minded couple in your love story. I see here within the Judgment card that you're not afraid of other people looking at you in a funny way, which is also why you're so different from your ancestors and just other people in your family. Like we spoke about in the Three of Cups and the Emperor, you having this type of relationship and being the first of this type within your lineage. So the Judgment card and also having the Three of Cups shows me here that you're celebrating your differences and you've come to a point where you're so mature and so sure of yourself and who you are as a person, and you're so sure of your path that you're not allowing for anyone's misplaced judgment to actually change your confidence levels whatsoever. You're just as confident before someone makes an unwanted comment as you are after you hear a comment that was completely unnecessary about your love life. Last but not least, for the first part of your prediction, we've got the Fool, which speaks of your love story being a completely fresh start for you, a completely fresh chapter. So your love story is not one you're going to embark on with someone who you already know. So make sure that you hold tight for part two of your reading, group number three, because that is based on your zodiac. And we will be going into letters within their name, birth chart placements. So know here in the Fool that they're not in your life yet. This is a completely new person with whom you are going to embark on this love story with. And it's important for you to keep an open mind, but also to follow and trust your instincts, as we have here within the symbol of the dog, which is a symbol of your instinct and trust, of course, but also ensuring that you always stay true to yourself and that you don't try to serve too many people, that you don't try to people please to the point that you're stifling your own romantic experiences. So group three, this is the first part of your reading that I received for you. I hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Make sure that you leave a little drink emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you made it to this part of your prediction. And of course, don't forget to click and hit your little zodiac sign timestamp in order to be fast forwarded committed to the second and even more personalized part of your reading. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during part two of your reading. Hello, group number four, and welcome to the first part of your love story prediction. You chose the Tarot of the Divine in connectivity to the Citrine Crystal, which is actually a crystal of wealth, abundance, material prosperity, you name it. But let's move into your reading in order to figure out exactly what your love story is going to look like and with whom this is going to play out with. So we have a few cards that popped right out of the pile for you. We've got the Two of Wands, the Lovers, as well as the Eight of Cups. So in the Lovers, I can immediately see here that your love story is definitely going to be a very passionate one. It's going to play out with someone who respects you, and I can definitely also see in the Two of Wands and the Eight of Cups that there are going to be some ups and downs. The Two of Wands shows me here that there will be moments in which you wish you were single or you wish that you were by yourself, and there will be moments that are filled with a lot of passion where you could not even imagine walking away from this connection ever, and you ask yourself how you ever thought that this person was getting on your nerves to this degree because they're just so lovely. So there are going to be a lot of interesting happenings. So I don't know about you, group number four, but this kind of sounds like the definition of a marriage. But let's move further into your reading to figure out exactly what your love story is going to look like. We've got the Knight of Cups, so you will be with someone who's empathetic and caring, and also to a certain degree a little bit needy, okay? They want your attention, they want your approval. They may not say it or show it, but your opinion really means a great deal to them, and it definitely also dictates how they feel about themselves, as I see here in the Knight of Cups and the Eight of Cups, that if you're not happy with them, that definitely also makes them feel very self-conscious and it makes them kind of unhappy with themselves. They first and foremost want to please you and want to ensure that you are feeling happy and content within the relationship. Next up, we've got the Moon. So in the Moon, I can see here that they are a very sensitive person on the inside, and this is a relationship that you intuitively know is right because this person can read you like a book. I see that here connected to the Lovers. You don't need to say what you need, what you're going through, what you're feeling. Your person already knows way ahead of time, all of my beautiful souls of group four. So this is really a soulmate relationship, a match made in heaven when it comes to understanding one another on an emotional and spiritual level. I also see here with the Lovers as well as the Knight of Cups that they are someone who is rather large when it comes to like their body, okay? They're someone who is most likely going to be bigger than you and make you feel really safe and protected. Next up, we've got the Death card. Ooh, 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 group number four. This is actually a positive card, despite what it may sound like or what types of feelings may come up when you read this card or when you see this card. It actually speaks of a completely new beginning. So I see that your relationship is going to go through a bunch of rebirths and a bunch of changes over time. You will have to go with the times and adapt with society and pop culture and everything that's happening around you in order to keep things on track, as you both are really into different types of cult finds and phenomenons. So think to yourself things such as Mean Girls, Clueless, Desperate Housewives, Gossip Girl, things like that, right? That just culturally gain a lot of traction and in a very certain group and demographic where it's just like, if you get it, you get it. If you don't, you don't. If you know that saying, and then you also know what I mean with you and your future lover having a lot of like inside jokes that other people wouldn't understand. I see here within the Hermit that you're both a little bit more on the introverted side. I can see that your love story is definitely going to be a private one. It's not one that you're going to parade around in the world or show off because you don't need to. You never need to worry about what the latest trends may be or anything like that, because your relationship is one that does not fade because maybe something else is in or something else is cool. So just because there is a certain beauty standard that a lot of people are adhering to, While you know all about it, you are not trying to change one another for it. You know that your relationship is simply going through another phase and era in this world, but it's going to be just as strong as ever. Next up, we've got the Four of Swords. So the Four of Swords shows me here that you both are definitely always hoping and praying that things stay this way, that you're able to adapt and be flexible just as the world continues to adapt. So whether there is like the newest dating technologies or you're just experiencing a complete shift in what people are into when it comes to communication, you're never using that to step out on the relationship or to step out on one another in any way, shape, or form. And you're both very hopeful that it can continue this way. Your love story is one that is definitely ideal when it comes to people who have control issues or who have trust issues, because you're both very fearful of that being broken or boundaries being overstepped when it comes to that. I can see here within the Ace of Swords that you're very innovative and creative, and this goes together beautifully, group number four, because you are constantly trying out new things. You're constantly looking at the world from different perspectives, and it makes for a very open-minded love story where you're also not afraid to try new things sexually, romantically, and sensually. I can see here within the Nine of Wands that sometimes feelings can get hurt, but you intuitively know that your person didn't mean it that way. But I can see here that for your love story, there are definitely phases where you ask yourself whether you're made for this type of very intense and passionate love, or where you ask yourself if it would have been better to be in a relationship that is filled with less emotion, less passion, less just wanting to express your desire and love for one another. And when things are tough, they are really tough in your love story, group number four. And it's important for me to be very honest with you and to tell you not just about the positives, but also, of course, about the challenges. And one thing that I want you to know here is that during tough times, the best thing you can really do is take the high road. The Two of Wands shows me that there are always different options and possibilities, and it can be very hard to admit this to yourself, but sometimes you do take the option of pain, even though love may have been one of the options. Choosing pain is something that I think a lot of us are kind of a little bit embarrassed to say that we've done that before, but it's okay, group number four. I don't feel as though you're the only one. It's definitely something that comes with time, with maturity and wisdom. I can see here within the Rattle that you simply need to vow to yourself to take more moments to think before you act, especially during disagreements in your love story, especially when you and your lover maybe have two very separate minds of issues, either in a societal way or when it comes to your relationship dynamic. But do know here that overall there is a lot of air sign energy, a lot of phallic energy within your love story. So look at it this way. We've got the Ace of Swords, we've got the Two of Wands, the Nine of Wands, the Four of Swords. We've got more phallic symbols within the Death card and the Rattle as well. Phallic means masculine, for any of you who did not know that, group four. So do know here that this masculine energy shows that you're constantly trying to improve. You're always trying to make the relationship work more seamlessly or effortlessly. And that is definitely something that not many people have the privilege to say they and their partner are truly doing or working on. So be proud of yourself, group number four, and remind yourself here that this isn't something that goes without say. Next up, we've got the Nine of Diamonds. The Nine of Diamonds shows me here that the person with whom you're going to be with, they have done a lot professionally speaking. They are definitely in a area code of their professional life or their career right now where there's just that little missing piece, that missing puzzle piece that you're going to add. The Nine of Diamonds shows me that they're kind of stuck in a very fortunate place. They want to get that one up so they can get that promotion, so they can have that financial success that they've always dreamt of. But it is definitely you who is that missing piece to give them that extra confidence, because right now with your love story, I see that the person with whom it's going to play out with, they're alone. They don't have anyone around them who is as supportive as you will be. And sometimes you just need that romantic partner to give you that extra confidence, that extra boost to push you forward. The Six of Crystals shows me here that you will definitely feel very triumphant when you get together with this person, when your love story plays out, because you will notice how things are going well for you, but also your lover. So it's not a one-sided affair. It's not just you uplifting your lover. It's definitely a mutually beneficial agreement and situation, group number four. So don't worry about that. And also keep in mind here in the Six of Crystals that adding to one another's lives, this is something that is like the foundation of a healthy love story and love life. And we have that here within your reading, which is a great sign. Next up, we've got the bouquet. In the bouquet, I can see that they are the type of person whose love language is most likely words of affirmation. So by love language, I mean that's how they show their love most of the times. They compliment you, they encourage you, they build you up, and they're most likely expressing themselves in this way to you so frequently because they would like more of that themselves. So with your love story, know that whatever you're receiving is what you're meant to give, because the person who's giving you these compliments, they want to receive that back. I can see here within the pale that if you feel as though right now your love story is not moving in this direction, it's time to get out of this situation. It's time to move on and make sure that you're with someone who is loyal, who is transparent, who respects you. The lovers in the Eight of Cups actually indicates this. The Eight of Cups is all about kind of leaving a situation or thinking of leaving a situation. And if they're not the type of person who you are crazy about and is crazy about you, and of course there are passionate moments or moments of anger where you feel like what you want to do is leave the person, but if you can't actually fathom doing that because you know that you are really meant to be with one another, then you're with the right one. But if you do think of leaving this person because they treat you in a disrespectful manner, they're not there for you, they're not loyal, then you know that it's time for you to really get out. As I can see here in the broken wishbone, that this wish of making something work that you can already tell or feel is not working because the trust, the honesty, the foundation of the relationship just isn't there, it's not going to happen, group number four. It is simply wishful thinking, which is why it's important for you to get out while you still have so much ahead of you, so much life force within you, and also so much internal and external beauty to explore and enjoy with someone who really deserves you. I can see here within the hand that if you're in need of help, assistance, or guidance, definitely don't be afraid to reach out, just as the hand suggests. Don't be afraid to reach out to someone close to you, maybe even a therapist, for help in order to make sure that your love story can play out the way that it should and that you don't stay in toxic situations that you truly just do not belong in, group number four. Let's add a few more cards into your reading just for some more details before we move into your zodiac signs part of this prediction. We've got Heart's Desires. The angels are supporting, guiding, and protecting you as your dreams become a reality. Keep that in mind. There's a reason why this card was called into your reading, group number four, and why you needed to receive this message right now after we got very real, very honest, raw, and your reading is definitely one that has some heavy elements, but you're here for it. I see that last but not least within crystals, that your connection to crystals and gemstones is a channel of healing energy, and to use that channel, especially if you don't own any crystals yet or you just don't really resonate or connect with the crystals that you have right now. Sometimes you just need to add a few more to the group in order to balance out the energies and create a type of dynamic that works with different stones. So don't be afraid to also pass crystals on to friends or donate them if they're not working for you any longer. And of course, also using crystals in order to help you out with your love life. There are tons of different love potions that you can make using crystals, love spells, all of those types of beautiful things. So don't be afraid to get a little creative, to use some divination in order to allow for your love life to play out as it should, and to charge your love story with the type of energy that it needs and that it deserves. So group number four, this is the first part of your prediction that I've received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below. Also, don't forget to leave a little horse emoji in the comment section to let me and others know that you were here, that you received this first part of your prediction. But now don't forget to click your zodiac sign's timestamp so we can move on to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction, where we will figure out things such as letters within their name, different placements within their birth chart, so we can really get down on the details of your love story and your lovers. So group number four, thank you for being here, and I'll catch you during part two of your prediction. Hello, all my beautiful Aries babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story reading. So let's get straight into it. Lean back, relax, and enjoy part two of your prediction. So let's find out exactly what's happening within your love story and some more details about your partner. So we've got the Sun, we've got the Knight of Bottles, as well as the Nine of Pills. So in the Sun, I can definitely see a good time coming towards you here. The Sun is one of the more favorable cards in the tarot. It is definitely a card that shows happiness, warmth, and joy. And I can see here within the Knight of Bottles that you have that feeling towards a water sign. So think to yourself a Pisces, a Scorpio, or a Cancerian. The Nine of Pills here shows me that with this person, you will find that your life is near perfect, and that just overall your love story is playing out beautifully, as there's nothing that you could wish or hope for that isn't in your life. There are only maybe one or two little areas of friction that still bother you. So when it comes to initials, we've got R as well as E. I'll just leave that right up here with the Knight of Bottles, who is someone who's emotionally intelligent. They can be a little bit impulsive and jump to conclusions at times, but as a whole, they are a very caring and empathetic, understanding type of person. But let's get further into your reading, shall we? So let's see what else we've got. Got rain when it comes to when you're going to meet them. So it's going to be kind of a rainy day, but it's not going to feel in any way like this is a bad symbol. This rainy day is more about purification and just all of the old energy being cleansed away, making space for your love story to begin. We've also got the Green Man, which shows me here that the rain is bringing a lot of growth. It's nourishing the earth, and I can see that this works beautifully with your love story. So rainy days, that's how your love story is going to start off. You're going to spend a lot of time with your lover indoors, and maybe even between the sheets, if you know what I mean, all of my beautiful Aries babies. But this is all going to work out beautifully for you, and rain will get a whole new meaning moving forward, because you no more feel as though rain is somehow dark and gray and sad, but it actually shows passion and being close to another person as you're associating it with your love story. The Nine of Wands here shows me that when it comes to your love story, there's definitely a part of you that is ready to move forward and that's ready to be within this love story already, but there's still one or two things that need to be done before you're ready for this, before you're ready for your Knight of Bottles and this person whose initials are ER. Next up, we've got the Queen of Coins. So in the Queen of Coins, I can see here that one of the things that you need to cut ties with is someone who has been holding some financial power over you. So think, for example, a boss or just someone who is higher up in the ranks than you are at your place of employment or academically. It could also be a motherly figure who you're living with or who is somehow supporting you. And in order for your love story to begin, you kind of need to be emancipated, so to say, my beautiful Aries babies, and move forward being able to cope without this person, because they can't be there with you every step of the way. And I can see that your love story has everything to do with you first being really independent. I see here within the King of Pentacles that the universe also does not want you to confuse the Queen of Coins with someone who necessarily has to identify as female. They may also identify as male, and they're definitely someone who can use their economic standpoint as an advantage and in order to make you kind of feel nervous around them. Within the Strength card, my beautiful Aries babies, I can see that your love story is a lot about your personal empowerment and inner strength and not being afraid to stand up against a bully or someone who is just overall kind of oppressing you in your life and not giving you the credit where credit is due. That is an important thing for you to overcome before you can move into your love story with this person. I see that the person with whom you're meant to live out your love story with is a builder. They're the type of person who can build and create. That brings them a deep sense of accomplishment. They may just look a little something like the builder, my beautiful Aries babies, which, you know, wouldn't be such a bad thing, I'd say. But all jokes aside, do know here within the builder that this is really someone with whom a relationship can blossom, because they're not afraid to build within the relationship, to add on more stories, more depth, to create little nooks and crannies in the relationship that just work in the sense of creating more peace, more tranquility, and harmony. I see here within infinite abundance that you're fully supported as you devote yourself to your divine life purpose. And the same goes for your person who is this builder person, who seems to have a very strong physical appearance that you're attracted to. As I do see here within the Justice card, that they have just the right amount of personality, brains, but also looks for you, my beautiful Aries babies, because of course personality is by far the most important thing, but at the same time, you also want to ensure that you are physically attracted to the person with whom your love story is meant to play out. Next up, we've got Aries. Oh, okay, my beautiful Aries babies, this reading is definitely made for you. And I can see here that you're meant to truly kind of live out these Aries tendencies of being independent, brave, and passionate, and not being afraid to cut those ties with this person, with this earth sign who has this hold on you when it comes to your career or your studies. You're meant to finish that first, maybe, you know, graduate first or just switch jobs first, stand up to someone who is not treating you with the respect and kindness that they should be treating you with before your love story can finally begin and blossom and all that good stuff can happen. We've got Pisces. So all of my beautiful Aries babies, the universe has spoken. I told you in the Knight of Bottles that you're meant to be with a water sign, right? With the initials E and R. The Knight of Bottles is all about that water sign energy, Pisces, Scorpio, and Cancerian. And what do you know? We had Pisces show up in your reading for you, which is the confirmation of your love story and who this is meant to be played out with. Pisces are great intimate partners, as they're the type of person who likes to be very close, who likes to share their innermost thoughts. They are very intuitive and compassionate. They're a very caring sign. And when they're in a relationship where they feel heard and where they feel like the other person truly values them, they are so devoted. So that's what I see for you, my beautiful Aries babies. Next up, we've got the Owl. You're going to receive great advice from a wise person when it comes to your love story, especially if you've been feeling frustrated or you just haven't been 100% sure about your love story and how it's meant to play out. I can see here that with your love story, you will also have money coming to you, financial success, wealth, and stability. So you will be building that with your person. The Justice card shows me here that the career within your love story that is going to bring all of this financial wealth and abundance brings fairness and protection to others who need the help. So either you or the person with whom you will be with has this job that brings really positive vibes into the earth and this planet and helps other people. And you may actually both be really successful in that, which would explain why you have so much of this infinite abundance and then the coins show up for you again. I can see here in the handshake that the person whom your love story is going to play out with is someone who is still a stranger, but meeting them is going to be one of the most important things in your life because, unbeknownst to you, you are going to be meeting the love of your life, the person with whom your love story is going to play out with, and this is just overall gonna be an amazing experience for you, my beautiful Aries. Moving further into your reading, we've got the Lotus Flower, which is all about allowing things to unfold in due time, my beautiful Aries babies. Remind yourself here that unfoldment can only happen if you also kind of leave things alone and let them happen in their own time. And remind yourself here with the ocean that life is this ebb and flow. Sometimes things will feel as though they're flowing effortlessly and beautifully, and sometimes there will be this ebb. There will be a situation where you feel as though all the things that you want are retracting and running away from you, and it's important for you to not run towards it and just kind of remain where you are and know that the flow will come towards you again. But all my beautiful Aries babies, overall, I want you to know that this is your personal love story prediction, and I really hope that you enjoyed this highly personalized two-part reading. As you most likely know, one of my favorite things to do is to create readings that are super personalized as well as interactive, and I really hope that you can appreciate that. Don't forget to leave a coin emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you are an Aries baby and that you received the second and even more personalized part of your prediction and that you claim it. Thank you so much for being here and spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Taurus babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction. So let's move straight into it so we can figure out more details about your love story and with whom your love story is most likely going to be unfolding with. So we've got the North Node, we've got Taurus, as well as Cancer. So one thing that I want you to know here within your reading is that you are destined to have someone who has these Cancer and Capricorn traits. So I do want you to understand here, all of my beautiful Taurus babies, that you are definitely a very patient, reliable, and sensual sign. You are ruled by Venus, which is all about beauty and all things that just feel good, passion. You get the picture. You like the finer things in life, and I can see that you're destined to have a love story that unfolds with someone who has those types of qualities. I can see here within the Cancer that you're meant to be with someone who is highly nurturing, who is all about providing you with comfort, peace of mind, and is also very protective of you. At the same time, this person has Capricorn placements within their birth chart, and they are ambitious. They take methodical steps forward, and they are also all about keeping things real. Of course, they are intuitive as a Cancer states, which is ruled by the moon, but at the same time, in Capricorn, it is completely clear that they are not fooled by intuition. They definitely also do think with their rational mind because they know that sometimes what you intuitively want can be coded by emotions such as fear or greed or love, and they like to make sure that everything that they do is going to be successful, whether that be a relationship with you, my beautiful Taurus babies, or a business move. Next up, we've got the Three of Wands. So in the Three of Wands, my beautiful Tauruses, they are climbing the ladder. This person with whom you're going to be with is definitely someone who is going further and further up the ladder when it comes to their personal success, but also their success academically and in their professional life. They're the type of person with whom you are going to reach new heights with, and with whom you're going to climb the social ladder. I can see here within the Empress that you're most likely also going to start some sort of family with them, whether it be with four-legged creatures, just animals in general, or whether it just be a marriage without any children. I want you to know here that you will be solidifying your relationship with them, as they are the type of person who wants to be in a committed situation that signals to the rest of the world that this is real and you mean it. So appearances are a little bit important to the person with whom your love story is going to play out with. Do know that the Empress is also a signal, a foreshadowing of a pregnancy, of children in general, offspring. So never say never, my beautiful Tauruses, as this is definitely part of your love story prediction. Next up, we've got the Sun. Your love story is going to be filled with happiness and well-being. So if you've ever worried or wondered about whether you will die alone or simply just be with your cat for the rest of your life, that is not what is happening, my beautiful Taurus babies. We also have a card that popped out of the pile, but that was off screen. I just picked it off of the floor, which is the Ear. So you're about to receive more good news when it comes to your love story. I mean, it's hard to believe that you have even more good news coming for you, my beautiful Taurus babies, because your love story reading has already been a very favorable and positive one, and we've already received quite a good amount of information about this person. Next up, we've got Light and Love. Your purpose is to bring divine healing, light, and love to this world. And I can see that your relationship is meant to embody that just as much, my beautiful Taurus babies. So definitely look forward to this lighthearted, fun relationship, and know here that this person is going to fulfill all of your heart's desires. The angels are supporting, guiding, and protecting you and your relationship as your dreams with your love story become a reality. And a little piece of advice that I would just like to give you, my beautiful Tauruses, is to not listen to any naysayers or to anyone who claims that you are too high maintenance or that you need to lower your standards. That is not the case whatsoever. Do not lower your standards for anyone, because when you lower your standards, you're basically saying it's okay for you to get less than what you deserve, and that's really not helpful for your self-confidence. So know here within the Ocean that of course there will be times where you're feeling more confident, and there will be times where you're feeling maybe a little self-conscious about your love life. But never allow yourself to stoop to the level of giving in to temptation, to momentary weakness with someone who doesn't see the beauty and value in having your heart or your physical body be theirs for a brief moment. Save yourself for the type of person who will truly appreciate you, and try not to make the mistake to give in to people who simply want to have some fun with you and then just kind of go and ghost the situation. Next up, we've got the Fog. So in the Fog, I can see here that your love story is right now kind of veiled. It's not very clear what is coming towards you in your love story in the next couple weeks and months, but overall we have a vague idea, but a lot is still shifting and changing within your existence, my beautiful Taurus babies. So that is a piece of information that you are meant to receive. Next up, we've got the letters R and B. So we have their initials and letters of their name right here. I'll leave that within Cancer for you. And I definitely want you to take these little pieces of advice with you when dating or looking out for a person with whom you suspect that your love story is going to be playing out with. Next up, we've got the High Priestess as well as the Knight of Diamonds. So the Knight of Diamonds corresponds beautifully within the Capricorn and also here in connectivity to the Sun. I can see that they're most likely going to have their Sun sign within Capricorn, as the Knight of Diamonds is basically the Knight of Earth. Capricorn Capricorn corresponds to the element of earth. This is an earth sign. So with the sun in the Knight of Diamonds, you know their sun sign is going to be Capricorn. They're someone who is still very young at this point in time. However, they are not so young that they're, for example, still dependent on another person, and they are ready to explore life and everything that life has to offer for them. In the High Priestess, I can see here that they are someone who is quite spiritual. They might also still have certain ties towards religion, or they've grown up in a religious family, but they've kind of created their own version of what they want to believe in because they turn their back on that, as I can see in the High Priestess and the Knight of Diamonds, that they're really figuring out for themselves what spirituality means to them, what prayer means, what God means, all of those different words, what the universe has to do with it. So they're the type of person who is super open-minded, super liberal, and kind of just figuring things out for themselves. They want to be loving and accepting towards all people, no matter their beliefs, and they wish for others to respect them in that very same way. So all of my beautiful Taurus babies, this is the reading that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found this insightful. Let me know down below by leaving a little sun emoji in the comment section. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Gemini babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction. So let's get straight into it. Lean back, relax, and enjoy what is coming towards your love life. So we've got Pisces, we've got sextile, as well as the 11th house. So we've got some indications as to what type of person you will be with and their placements. We've got Pisces as well as the 11th house. So in Pisces, I can see that the person with whom your love story is going to play out with is someone who is intuitive, compassionate. They really love intimacy, both emotional intimacy as well as physical intimacy. And as you would expect with the 11th house, I can see here that they also are very close to their friends, family, and people who are like-minded, who have the same humanitarian beliefs. They're a very deep person. And with the sextile, I can see that your love story is all about a combination of tension and flow, potential, and a rewarding situation. So your love story is meant to be very interesting and dynamic and keep you guessing during certain periods of time. As a Gemini, you're very adaptable, you're very versatile and quick, youthful and lively. So being with someone who can kind of hold their own next to you and who can also keep you interested, I'd say that's pretty vital. Next up, we've got the Eight of Wands, which is an indication of speed, and in the world, I can see fulfillment. The world is actually one of the most favorable cards within the tarot, and I can see that what you're really loving, my beautiful Gemini babies, is the fact that there is a lot of speed here in your love story, and that things are never in a place where you feel like they're boring or like you've kind of already seen the scenario play out a million times over. So you're constantly being entertained. We've got the letters E as well as Y when it comes to their initials. So take that as a little piece of information for yourself, my beautiful Geminis. Next up, we've got Fire. This is a very passionate relationship you're meant to be in. And in East, I can see some emergence. So I want you to know here that passion for you comes from a place of keeping things interesting, of moving things along quickly. You like a quick pace. You like to be challenged mentally, and you're definitely someone who needs to be stimulated in that way. I see here within the flag that you're being called to not lower your standards, especially if you don't end up in this love story right now or within the next couple days, all my beautiful Gemini babies. Don't become so impatient because you like quick movement and a fast pace that you lower your standards and end up with someone who isn't the person you are supposed to be with. it is truly essential that you stick to what you know you really want and desire, and that you don't compromise on it. In the bell, I can see here that when things get kind of heated, it is important for you to be very careful and wary of your words, as sometimes as a Gemini, you can tend to have a little bit of a sharp tongue, and that is something that can hurt your love story. The filled chair shows me that someone new will be entering your life. So your love story is not going to play out with someone who is already in your life, my beautiful Gemini babies. This is going to be a completely new person who you've never met before. Next up, we've got the door. So when you unlock that door, when you go beyond that door, there will be lots of opportunities that you didn't expect waiting for you. And just overall, your love story is an unexpected one. You're not going to see this coming. The person is not in your life yet with whom this love story is going to play out with. And I can see here within the wolf that when you do meet them, you will instinctually know that you have met the one. Next up, we've got the wind as well as music. So it's going to be a pretty windy day that will activate your love story, and there will be a specific piece of music that you're listening to. So you will have a song with this person. Your love story is going to have some sort of theme song. So think you listening to a very specific piece of music when you meet your person, or just overall during your first kiss, for example, having a specific song in the background, making that your song, being a tune that you love to listen to that reminds you of a time where you were in love or you met the love of your life. Next up, we've got the Two of Swords. In order to allow for your love story to play out, you can't overthink things, and that can be a little hard for Geminis, I understand, but you have to try, my beautiful Gemini babies. Don't give up on getting yourself to a place where you do things in an intuitive sense, where you don't ask yourself constantly if you made the right choice or not, because I can see here in the Five of Wands that that will just cause a lot of internal emotional mental friction that you really just do not need, because that will mess with your creativity. And now your love story is all about, well, love and having a good time. So don't allow for your mind to take away from that. Remind yourself here within the Hierophant that there are things that are so much greater than we are, and the best thing you can do is kind of allow for life to flow and to happen and not constantly meddle with it or get in between of destiny. I want you to know here within the Hierophant that you're also someone who carries a lot more wisdom within themselves than they realize, and I see that your love story truly thrives off of this type of generational wisdom that was passed down to you. The Four of Swords here shows me that when it comes to overthinking, it is definitely a little bit of a work in progress. I'm not even going to try to cover that up for you, my beautiful Geminis, but you are an air sign. You are always filled with a racing mind, with thoughts that are kind of going everywhere. That's pretty normal for you, but I want you to know here that your love story seems to keep up with your pace and seems to be just as charming, fun, and witty as you are. So I hope you're looking forward to it, and I hope that you're excited for your love story to play out. So all of my beautiful Gemini babies, I definitely want you to know here that following your instinct will allow for you to jumpstart your love story. You haven't met the person at the time of you watching this reading, but do know here that the more you go through doors and take steps forward and you listen to your instinct rather than overthinking your actions, the more you will actually draw this person into your life with whom your love story will play out with. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me. Don't forget to leave a little fish emoji, as we have here for Pisces, down below in the comment section to let me and others know that this is the reading that you received, that you were here, and this is the reading that you received, and that you enjoyed it. I appreciate you, and thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my fellow Cancerians, and welcome to this second and even more personalized part of your love story reading. So let's get straight into it so we can figure out all the nitty-gritty little details about your love story. So we've got the island. Maybe you'll meet them on an island, my beautiful Cancerians. Next up, we've got winter solstice as well as fire. So I want you to know here in the island and winter solstice that you will meet your person during a time of reflection and solitude. So during a time in your life when you're actually thinking to yourself, I'm okay with being by myself, with being single, I'm okay being really reflective, all of a sudden, bam, you'll have some passion show up in your life. You will feel as though there is a spark of fire that's been ignited, and like you have found the lover with whom you would like to embark on a fresh journey with. So it is going to be a very unexpected romance, and your love story is full of twists and turns that you didn't think were coming towards you. But maybe that's the beauty of you just allowing for life to flow and you being in a spot of self-reflection and not overthinking love or your love story. That seems to be the time where you're actually most susceptible to passion, to romantic love and fun. Next up, we've got the Ten of Diamonds. The Ten of Diamonds does also show me here that the person with whom your love story is going to play out with is someone who adds to your professional life and also adds to you in an academic sense. You love to learn together, to grow with one another, and to push each other to be better. Next up, we've got the Queen of Diamonds. So they're definitely super supportive about you being a boss, you getting your coins, and also having big deals take off for you, big business deals. They are not the type of person who is jealous or who feels as though they are in competition with you. And within strength, I can see here that compared to all the exes that the person you're with had, you are the only one who's able to tame this person. So they may have been not necessarily unloyal, but not as tame as they are with you. With their exes, they were committed, but not as committed. You just kind of give it that extra edge, that extra bit of love, my beautiful Cancerians. You truly are the type of person who changes your lover for the better, makes them more committed, and makes them honestly kind of obsessed with you. Next up, we've got Saturn. So in Saturn, I can see here that it is important for you to keep in mind that within your love story, a big piece of just learning that needs to be done is to learn hard work as well as patience and to know how to get through times of struggle. So Saturn definitely shows me here that your love story is not just all roses and someone being completely obsessed with you and infatuated by your presence, but it's also about learning to be the best versions of one another and balance one another out. Yang is all about masculine energy, so we have all the air and fire signs within here. I want you to know that masculine energy is all about being proactive, being expressive, doing, and forward motion. And these are all ways in which your person balances you out, because you are, of course, a feminine sign, my beautiful Cancerians, and it's important for you to have that balance, which we can see here within passion, that the person with whom you will be with has a bit of that fiery energy. And furthermore, within Yang, we have more fire sign indications. So this is getting quite interesting. Let's see what else we've got for you. We've got the Three of Coins, we've got the Six of Wands, the Queen of Coins, which is actually identical to the Queen of Diamonds, as well as the Ten of Swords. So let's talk about the Queen of Coins showing up twice within your reading. So you're very smart with your finances, and your love story is also going to confirm that. As you move forward, you will see that actually your love story brings you security in your professional life, but also financially speaking. The Six of Wands shows me here that you'll be able to secure some pretty big things that you've wanted, such as a dream home, a dream vehicle, some dream items that you've always wanted within your life. The Three of Coins shows me here that it's important for you to be wary of sketchy business partners, and the same goes for your love story. The person with whom you'll end up with, they have some family and some people surrounding them who want a little piece of your pie that you've built with your person. And I see here within the Ten of Swords that as soon as you kind of set boundaries with your family, but also your person's family, you will find that they kind of disappear, and they do so without a fight, okay? They just are not going to be trying to get your attention or to talk to you very much anymore. And it'll be painful because you will inevitably notice that they were just around you or reaching out to you because they wanted something from you. But at the same time, it's also kind of good that now you know and you can move forward without feeling guilty for not wanting to share everything you've worked so hard for with people who did not put in the work. I see here within water that your person is going to allow you to fully express yourself the way that you see fit and the way that is the most comfortable for you. And I see here within sea creatures that they absolutely love the fact that you're a water sign. They love that you're expressive. They love that you're the type of person who doesn't just paint a picture when they're telling a story, but you actually feel all the feels when you're speaking. You feel as though you're in that scenario with you, and you're just the type of person who lives very close to their emotions and their feelings and isn't afraid of showing that. When it comes to their initials, we've got B as well as D for you as little indicators. And I'll just leave them right here within the winter solstice for you. And furthermore, we have a few more bits of information, such as the barrel, which is all about feeling as though something is lacking within your life. And that is actually something that channels a lot of strength for you, as I can see here, as mentioned previously in the island, as well as the winter solstice, that when you feel like something is kind of lacking, you tend to be okay with it. You tend to get over it and decide that rather than seeing it as lack, you're going to learn to live with it, which is when your love story actually begins, when you least expect it and when you're least craving someone. That's when an exciting event is going to take place. You'll be invited to some sort of party or get together where you can meet your person. Next up, I want you to know here within the ladder that your love story is going to help you to climb towards success and is also going to allow you to gain a higher standing in society's hierarchy and to kind of climb up society's ladder, if you will. Not that that's something that you necessarily wanted or needed, as I can see within Saturn that it also brings a dark side with it, but do know that this is something that you can manage, my beautiful Cancerians, and you can be the one real person in the room who shows everybody else that you don't have to constantly conform to society standards or do what popular celebrities or just people on the internet are doing. You can be different. So all of my beautiful Cancerians, this is the reading that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section. Leave a little fire emoji down there to let me and others know that you were here and you received the second and even more personalized part of your prediction. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming readings. Hello, all my beautiful Leo babies. And welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story reading. So let's get into it, shall we? I'm really excited to see what's coming towards all of my beautiful Leo babies in love. So first up, we've got wind as well as the dragonfly. And last but not least, we've got the clouds. So do know here within the clouds and wind, it's going to be a windy and cloudy day when your love story kind of begins and you are emerged within it and you're able to dive into this world of love that's coming towards you that is different from where you are right now. As a Leo baby, you're a very generous and warm-hearted, creative person, and you're faithful and loving, so it is important for you to be able to feel safe when you're giving someone your heart. I see here within the Page of Cups that we've got the Page of Water Signs, so do know here that water signs include Cancerians, Scorpios, and Pisces, and in the Page of Cups we have a young water sign that plays some sort of important role within your love life, but it could also just be you channeling very young water sign energy because you're not yet quite used to expressing your emotions and it's all new to you. So just like the page, you have to learn everything from scratch. Next up, we've got the moon and the knight of swords. So in the moon and knight of swords, I can see here that you intuitively know when someone is speaking to you in a manner that you appreciate and agree with, or if someone is kind of, how should I say, being a little sneaky, condescending. And the moon shows me here in the Knight of Swords that no matter how much someone sweet talks you, you can tell by the tone of their voice and their body language what they're really thinking and whether what they're saying actually does correspond with how they feel deep on the inside about you. So you're great at reading people's body language in the clouds. I want you to know that you're great at discerning whether someone is a shapeshifter and just will go with whatever wherever the wind blows them, or whether they actually have any type of strong opinion. Next up, in the Knight of Coins, I do also see here that when it comes to making money, you are going to be at a place where you're doing quite a lot of things with your romantic partner. So you're not going to be doing everything by yourself. The Hierophant is a card that was turned around within shuffling. So I do want you to know that this has significance. And within the Knight of Coins, I see that rather than feeling like money is super important or material possessions are a big deal, you're drifting away from that type of thought process. And you're kind of more in a place where you understand that while money is helpful, it isn't everything, and your spiritual growth and well-being is worth so much more than finances. And you're rejecting any type of person who is trying to impress you with money or who is trying to make you like them more just because of what they can offer you in the earthly realms or gifts that they may want to give you. Next up, we've got the Hanged Man as well as the Three of Wands. So do know here within the Hanged Man that your love story is going to be a little bit complacent for some time. Now, this complacency is happening as you're figuring out what your love story is shaping up to be like. And I do want you to know here within the Three of Wands that you're all about allowing things to just happen and do whatever they need to do in order to emerge victoriously and successfully. So you're not messing with the process of the universe kind of creating your love life for you and channeling someone into your private space. I can see here within the bowl that the less you actually care about material things, the more you're gaining them, the more they're coming towards you. So because you're not someone who is shallow, contrary to popular beliefs about Leos, I can see here that that's actually why you're super successful. That's also why a lot of people feel as though maybe you're shallow, maybe you're pompous, or you brag. It's not because you're trying to do that, it's because you don't really attach your self-worth and value to these material things. So when they so easily and gracefully come towards you, people think that you've worked really hard for it, or you've tried really hard to be in this position because that's their reality, but it's not in fact what actually happened for you. Next up, we've got Leo. So it's very clear that this reading is for you and that you are being called to use your Leo tendencies of being more self-confident than the other signs, very loyal as well as creative, in order to activate a love life that allows you to fully be embodied in your love and feeling very comfortable to share your heart, feeling comfortable to share your innermost thoughts and your inner world. In opposition, I can see that being with another Leo, that's not for you. It will create an imbalance, a point of tension, and a power struggle. So steer clear of other Leos and just in fact fire signs. I don't really see that working out for you here within your reading. I see in the Page of Cups and Knight of Coins that actually rather water or earth signs work better for you. Next up, we've got the Fourth House, which is all about cultural and family roots, your home, peace, and comfort. Know here within the Hanged Man that once you've found something that works, you're going to stick to it. You're not going to try to change anything, or you're not going to try to fix a system that isn't broken. And I can see here within yin that, just as mentioned earlier, water and earth signs are for you. Yin is all about feminine energy. Now, what are the feminine signs? Well, all of the water as well as earth signs. So think Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Pisces, Cancerian, as well as Scorpio. Those signs are the ones who are more intuitive, who are all about spirituality and receptivity. They are very patient and they balance you out beautifully, my Leo babies, because you are filled with masculine, phallic type of energy. So you're going to want to go with a Page of Cups person who is that water sign, who is most likely a little younger than you, or the Knight of Coins, who is roughly around your age. So next up, we've got the letters P as well as I. Use that in order to discern whether you are actually heading down this direction in your love story, as these letters are great indicators you can use while dating. Furthermore, I do want to add just a little more information about your love story. We've got a healer. Okay, so you're meant to be with someone who works in a profession that has to do with health, with the medical field. I can see here that you are meant to be with someone who has a deep, profound desire to heal others. And I see with an oracle cards that tarot and oracle cards, just divination tools, are going to be guiding you for a very long time. They're going to be accompanying you on your journey in your love life and your love story for years and years to come. Next up, we've got the tsunami as well as a dream time. So know that on one hand, within a dream time, that being in this space where spirituality and divination is nothing new to you allows you to be more creative, which is a really great attribute that you bring to your love story. You're the one who is more dreamy, more creative within the relationship, whereas I see here within the tsunami, the healer, that the person with whom your love story is going to play out with is the type of person who likes to take action, who had some sort of wake-up call within their life that propelled them to work within the medical profession, which is also why it is so important for you to maintain the feminine energy that you bring to the table. Never feel as though your emotions or feelings are too much, because that is what your person appreciates you for. So don't forget to allow yourself to express the feminine tendencies that you two possess within your relationship. It is super important for you to do so, even though the person with whom you're going to be with most likely belongs to one of these feminine sun signs. You too have a feminine side to you, and it's important for you to allow for that to be a part of the relationship, to never feel like it's too much or like you're overwhelming anyone. So all my beautiful Leo babies, this is the second part of your love story that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section by leaving a little cloud emoji below to let me and others know that you were here and that you enjoyed this reading. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Virgo babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story. So let's move straight into it so we can figure out exactly with whom your love story is going to play out with, and all of the other little details about your romantic life. So we've got Gemini, we've got Fire, as well as Cancer. So we've got very prominent Gemini and Cancerian placements within their birth chart. I can see here within Gemini that they are someone who is very curious, whose intellect is on a high level, and who is very witty, fun, as well as youthful and lively. They're really good at networking, talking to other people, so they are kind of the outgoing one in the relationship. I can see that your love story is destined to be filled with someone who has a lot of confidence, optimism, passion, and bravery. And at the same time, when you have your private moments and you're by yourselves, I see here within Cancer that they're very nurturing, comforting, and protective over your relationship and you as a person, my beautiful Virgos. you can be on the more modest and shy side. So being with someone who is more outgoing, who is more extroverted, is definitely a great way to ensure that your relationship never gets boring or feels as though it's always just the two of you. This is the type of person that can keep up with friends, that can make sure that you're maintaining your social life in a healthy manner without kind of spiraling into hermit mode for too long at a time. Next up, we've got the Chariot. So all my beautiful Virgo babies, I can see here that your love story is meant to play out pretty soon. I can see in the Chariot that you're moving forward at a pretty quick pace in your life right now, and your love story is very close to beginning, or you're even in midst of your love story already. I see here within the Six of Cups that it's important for you to open up, emotionally speaking, because you can definitely be the type of person who keeps a lot of things to themselves. So it's important for you to remember that it's cool to open up to others. It doesn't make you a burden. And within your love story, it's actually a really important skill for you to develop, being open and talking, saying what it is that you need. In the Knight of Crystals, I can see here that you are the type of person who has a lot of development ahead of them. The Knight of Crystals shows me here that you've already come really far in the last couple years, but you still have a lot of growth before you. So being with someone who has strong Gemini and a Cancer placements is a true blessing, because they're the type of person who will be able to celebrate your personal growth and development. They are the type of person who will have your back and be 100% understanding about the fact that you don't want to be complacent in your life and in your existence. I see here within the Ant that it's all about teamwork. You're going to work really hard with one another in order to accomplish great things and get all of these successes in your lives that you've dreamt of. And furthermore, I want you to know here within the Ant that your love story is meant to be one of family and also just being team players. So having a big family is something that you maybe didn't expect for yourself, or just having your love story play out surrounded by a lot of family. But do take your lover into account as well, and their type of family history and background, because that plays an integral role in your love story as well. And know here in the Ant that it is definitely going to be a little crowded, your love story. There's going to be more social contact than you're maybe used to, because as a Virgo, you're most likely more of an introvert, an empath, and you value your space and your alone time. But I definitely see that this is going to push you out of your comfort zone in many situations, where you will actually find that it has taught you a lot about yourself, and it's all always temporary. That is what I see here within the Tent. It's important for you to remind yourself that every chapter in your love story is temporary, so take all that you can out of those chapters, whether it be a challenging chapter where you're learning a lot about yourself and how to deal with and handle other people, or whether it be a chapter that is filled with romance and love and affection. Definitely enjoy every single moment and every chapter individually, and in a sense, without thinking of the future, without overthinking what is to come next, but simply being within the moment. I see here within the Knot that it's also essential for you to remember that when things don't work out with you and family or lovers, it's also a very temporary situation. That doesn't mean that the relationship is doomed. That doesn't mean that your love story is not in a good place, my beautiful Virgo babies. It is normal for some plans to simply not work out, and you have to be strong and move on. I can see here that we've got the letter E as well as A when it comes to important letters within your person's name. So I hope you can take this little extra juicy piece of information, write it down, or just keep it in mind when it comes to your love story. Next up, we've got the Justice card. So for Justice, I can see here that you have to decide pretty intuitively along your love story whether you're happy with how you're being treated or not. While we do have very clear placements when it comes to your person with whom your love story is going to be playing out with, it is definitely also important for you to make sure that you're with someone who is emotionally very caring and understands that you are a modest person, you are someone who is very analytical, and you need someone who can appreciate that and not constantly criticize it. As I see here within the Seven of Bottles, that you've had your fair share of criticisms and just people in your life who don't quite understand you and how you function, and who maybe try to be a little too up in your business or make too many comments about how they feel like you should be living your life. So I can see here that in your love story, there is no space for that. The Four of Knives shows me that there is a situation where you feel as though you've been backstabbed here. I see that your love story is one where you're being very assertive about who is allowed to be within the realm of you and your lover and who isn't, because there are definitely some friends and family who pretended to want the best for you or for your love story, but they actually really are kind of jealous and lonely and bored, so they are not opposed to trying to sabotage your relationship. I can see here within the Knight of Cigarettes that this is a fire sign who's doing that. This is a fire sign who is roughly around your age, or at least acts around your age. They may biologically be a lot older. So think of, for example, a narcissistic parent, or just overall someone who should be more mature, but they aren't. And it is important for you here in connectivity to the Justice card to see their actions and their behavior for what it is, which is that it's not okay, my beautiful Virgo babies, and to distance your love life, your love story, from anybody who isn't in support and who isn't giving you what you need in order to be able to fully enjoy your love story. Next up, we've got the Ceremony. So within the Ceremony, I can see here that when it comes to your love story, there's going to be some sort of a party, some sort of, you know, wedding type situation along the line, which may come in a very unexpected sense, but nevertheless, it's here for you. And I can see within Lightning that this is giving you a lot of power within the relationship. It's giving your relationship a new meaning, and you have a fresh understanding of what the dynamic is within the relationship. So it could be that you were the one who was a little bit more attached or needy until you got married, and then all of a sudden the roles reversed. It could also be vice versa, but I want you to understand here that the more you solidify your love life and your relationships, the more you will find that there are definitely some people who are a little bit jealous about your love story. Next up, we've got the Rainbow. Nevertheless, your life is filled with a lot of amazing blessings, my beautiful Virgo babies. I can see here within the Rainbow that this is definitely something that you've maybe taken for granted in the past, and it's now time for you to remember that your love story is one of the more beautiful and very idyllic ones. As I can see within Ancestors, that your ancestors and the generations that came before you, they did not have the privilege that you have to live out your love story in such a modern type of way, in such a fun sense of simply being, living, experiencing, loving on someone and being loved on, and just overall having this fun interactive dynamic with another person who is kind of the polar opposite of you, but it works beautifully because they push you to be better and get out of your comfort zone regularly. So all of my beautiful Virgo babies, this is the reading that I received for you. Leave a little butterfly emoji down below in the comment section if you made it to the end of part two of your prediction. Thank you so much for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Libra babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction. So let's get straight into it. So lean back, relax, and enjoy your reading. We've got the winter solstice, we've got the island. What else do we have? Fire. Okay, so I can see here that your love story is going to play out in private. You're not going to share your love life with a lot of people, as I can see here in the winter solstice and the island, that you've learned your lesson that, especially in the early stages of relationships, it's best to keep some things to yourself rather than sharing it with others, as you never know what another person's intentions are. Now, their intentions may not be to ruin your relationship, but if they want you all to themselves, they may end up causing a lot of friction between you and your potential future lover. I see here within the island that your relationship is definitely going to seem as though it is simply you and this person, and there's a lot of passion there, a lot of fire, and for a very long time, it is definitely just going to be you and a partner, my beautiful Libra baby, so not necessarily adding any extra family into the picture or having children or anything like that. I can definitely see that you're a very romantic sign, but at the same time, that doesn't mean that you want to immediately skip the honeymoon phase and move into bringing other individuals into your relationship dynamic. I see here within the Queen of Knives that you're actually really well thought out and you want to enjoy every stage of your love story as an individual part of the cycle and make the most of it, really live in the moment. The Queen of Knives corresponds to the element of air because the suit of knives is basically the suit of air, so Libras, Aquarius babies, as well as Geminis, and I can see that because you care so much about your person and your love story is playing out in such a passionate type of way, you definitely want to enjoy every stage, be it a honeymoon stage, be it a stage where you're growing with one another, moving in, spending more time working together, whatever it is, you want everything to be felt and seen and experienced. I see here within the Seven of Knives that an important thing for you is definitely loyalty. And if loyalty isn't there within your love story or somebody betrays you, that's it. You're gone. You're leaving the building. As I see within the Seven of Pills, that it's not really an option for you to continue being with someone or working with someone who has betrayed you, even if it was just one time. As a Libra, you are a highly diplomatic sign. You are very sociable and easygoing, but when someone crosses the line with loyalty, say cheating with another person romantically, or crossing the line financially by not telling you the truth and doing some shady things that they really shouldn't have been doing, that's it for you. When someone shows you their true colors, you believe them the first time, my beautiful Libra babies. And I definitely respect you a lot for that, as a lot of signs struggle to remove themselves from toxic relationships or relationships that then turn toxic. I can see here within Scorpio that we've got some very intense energy in your love story. As well as in Virgo, we've got more earthy energy, which is all about reverence, service, as well as integrity. So the mixture of this person is really well fitted towards what you need, my beautiful Libras, because again, you need loyalty, you need someone who is very honest and real, who has integrity, just as we have here within Virgo, but at the same time is also not afraid to renew things, right? To talk things over, to go into depth in discussions and emotional situations. They're not afraid of emotions and feelings. So I can definitely see that for your person, important signs within their birth chart are Virgo as well as Scorpio. Now let's see what type of letters that we have when it comes to their names. So we've got L as well as A. I'll leave that right here on the island for you, all of my beautiful Libras, but let's move further into your reading so we can get some extra information for you. So we've got the Wheel, indecisiveness, allowing your life to ramble aimlessly. Isn't that the story of every Libra? Being kind of indecisive, trying to make sure everything is balanced out, so to say, and kind of struggling to simply allow life to happen at times, and this indecisiveness actually not helping you move forward more quickly, but doing quite the opposite, because you're going back and forth a lot and you're struggling to make up your mind. But I see here within the Ant that your love story is all about teaming with someone with whom you can work together, achieve great goals and successes, and who has the same type of diplomatic streak within them as you do. I can see here within the Tent that your love story is going to have some temporary situations within them, and they are temporary because, as already mentioned, it is important for you to have someone's full loyalty and to be able to trust them. So there will be some temporary relationships where people kind of break your trust or misuse your trust, and then you're out of there. You're no longer in the situation, in the relationship. That's why we've got these temporary situations, as well as the Seven of Knives and the Seven of Pills. You also will listen to your gut instinct, so if you suspect that someone hasn't been honest to you along your romantic journey, you will listen to your gut feeling first rather than what it is that they are saying. You may tell them that you believe them, but if in your heart of hearts you don't think that this person is telling the truth, you're not going to stick around for it. You're definitely going to listen to your hunch and your instinct. Next up, we've got the Five of Wands, which is all about protecting yourself, defending yourself. And I can see that you're very protective over your heart, your time, as well as your energy. And this is something that you should be proud of, my beautiful Libras, because far too many of us are giving our time, our physical temples to people who don't properly appreciate it or don't properly see its value. That is where I can see in the Temperance card that you really know how to keep your lust or your want and need for physical contact, love, and romance. You can keep that all at bay until you found the right person, because what you're not going to do is lower your standards just because you're in the mood to be with someone or you feel lonely. No, no, no. That is not you, my beautiful Libra babies. I can see here in the Hierophant that during your love story, it becomes very clear that you know your self-worth and value, and that this is something that you're not going to compromise on, because guess what? You don't need to, and you're not asking anyone else to do that for you, so why should someone else ask you to do that for them? Next up, we've got the Ten of Swords. The Ten of Swords shows me here that you're moving on from relationships that feel hurtful, that feel like just something isn't right. You're not giving any second, third, fourth chances. That is just not in your itinerary. And it's something to feel proud of, as I can see here that within your love story, you're kind of being very cutthroat, because you understand that indecisiveness has only kept you complacent or wasted your time unnecessarily. Within the Journey, I can see that you're holding on tightly to what you want, what you've put on maybe your goal or visualization board. If you don't know how to make a goal or visualization board, I actually have a video of how to make a manifestation goal and visualization board on my channel, so feel free to check that out. I even filmed that with my husband and show you my goal board as well as his for the year 2022 as an example. So do know here within the Journey that what you put out there as a manifestation and as a goal to visualize is definitely something that you can draw into your life that can become a reality. I want you to know here within the Lodge that just asking people who have come before you on this journey, who have created a love life for themselves out of their own manifestations, a love life that they've always wanted, ask those people how they did it and how they went about finding the right person, sticking to their guns, and overcoming loneliness and overcoming a feeling as though solitude is really pulling a number on you, if you know what I mean, my beautiful Libras. So don't be afraid to ask others for advice when it comes to relationships or dating. So all of my beautiful Libra babies, this is the reading that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section by leaving a little tent emoji down there. Thank you so much for sharing this divine time and space with me, and I can't wait to speak to you in one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, my beautiful Scorpio babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your prediction, where we figure out exactly what your love story is going to be, who it's going to play out with, and all of the nitty-gritty little details in between. We've got Yin, we've got Cancer, as well as Mercury. So this is a very interesting combination, my beautiful Scorpio babies, as I can see here within Yin that we've got femininity being part of your love story. So being with a lot of feminine energy, so a feminine sign, which means either an earth sign or a water sign. And who would have thought we had Cancer show up for you? So you being with this fellow water sign, I can see, is creating a love story that is filled with trust, patience, spirituality, and receptivity. Furthermore, being with a Cancerian means to be with someone who's nurturing, comforting, as well as very protective. And while you may think that your love life is maybe filled with a little too much feminine energy, may I remind you here that within this Mercury placement, we've got networking, communicating, thinking, learning, and not being afraid to change your mind, to see things from a different perspective and viewpoint. So your relationship is definitely a very dynamic one. Your love story is going to play out with someone who is willing to listen, who has a strong Cancerian placement, either in their rising or their sun sign, and who also kind of feeds off of the fact that you are a learner as well, that you're the type of person who never feels as though they've already learned everything or know everything. They really love that you can feed off of one another intellectually, and that you're also keen to network with other people and not just stay in your own little bubble. Next up, we've got the Shaman. In the Shaman, I can see some ancient healing wisdom being part of your love story. So taking an interest in indigenous medicines, cultures, and traditions is a big part of your love story, maybe because you or your lover actually have connections to indigenous ancient healing wisdom, but maybe it's just also a personal thing that you're looking into, that you're super fascinated by, and you respectfully just want to explore the culture and how other people have lived for many, many centuries, and some of them continue to live. Next up, we've got the initials E as well as R. So ER shall give you a nice little understanding of important letters within your person's name. And once again, remember here within Yin that we have very receptive and patient feminine type of energy. So your person is really the one that takes things on board, that maybe overthinks a little bit as well within your love story, and you're the one who brings a lot of fun energy to the table. I see here within the Bear that you both are going to go through some very dangerous money matter situations together, which is why it is so important that you talk to one another, that you communicate, that you bounce ideas off one another. I see that here in the Green Man and Mercury, that whenever you and your person get a little too in over your heads with a financial decision, or it's just some sort of investment that has to do with money, you will find that you will be pushed back. So learning, as we have here within Mercury, as well as exchanging your ideas within the Green Man, and you learning certain things as well as your partner learning certain things, and then combining that knowledge into one big ball, that is going to allow you to be victorious. So V stands for victory in some sort of endeavor, and having spoken about your money matters and how when things go right, they go extremely well within your love story, and when things don't go well, when things go left, they really do go into some sort of dangerous territory. It is important for you to be mature, to not make hasty or impulsive decisions, and to not kind of just believe anyone blindly who seems to be telling a great story about how they can make you a lot of money if you just, you know, invest a little bit in this scheme or that. Make sure that you're being very careful together as a couple within your love story when it comes to finances, because you have a lot of potential for growth, but also a lot of potential to make decisions that aren't very wise with one another. So I hope you can appreciate my honesty, all of my beautiful Scorpio babies. Leave a little scorpion emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you understand and that you're with me. So we've got the Eight of Cups, we've got the Chariot, as well as the Princess of Cups. So I can see here within the Princess of Cups, the Eight of Cups, and the Chariot that you are both quite emotional beings. I can see that within your love story, there will be times where you want to walk away, as we have here in this minor arcana card that belongs to the Suit of Cups. But we also have here in the Chariot, moving forward with one another, which is a major arcana card. Now, I want you to remember here that the major arcana cards speak of major life events, and the minor arcana are more the little day-to-day things. So it's important for you to not fall into just petty traps or being petty with your partner along your journey to love or your love story, because I can see that that is something that eats away at you. And in the Princess of Cups is a very small-minded type of frame of mind to just be petty, to forget how fortunate you are within your love story. That is something that you run risk of. So being very real with yourself and understanding that the universe is bringing you these messages to protect you and your love story is an important factor of your romantic life. As I see here within the Chariot, that you're destined to grow with your person, you're destined to thrive, you're destined here within the Queen of Pentacles to make amazing financial decisions, but you have to find a way to get past little day-to-day arguments or points of friction. Next up, we've got the Emperor. Someone needs to be in the lead, okay, my beautiful Scorpio babies? You cannot be sharing every single task along your love story journey. One person needs to be in charge of, for example, spending with groceries. Another person needs to keep tabs on insurances, things like that, okay? You both need different areas of the relationship which you can lead, in which you have control, so to say. Of course, you communicate with the other person and you check in with them, but ultimately, we need little kingdoms for you and your person to be able to rule over, to feel as though you have a say in those areas of the relationship. And that way, it's also less confusing. You're not wasting so much time looking at the same thing and maybe disagreeing with it. You both have areas in which you're experts, and that serves you really well. I see here within the Trickster that your love story is going to come with some challenges when, again, it comes to this power dynamic and a bit of a power struggle. Both being water signs, you as well as your Cancerian partner with who this love story is going to play out with, you can both get in your feels, you can get a little sensitive, and in those moments, it's truly important to remind yourself of what's important and why you're with this person to begin with, and why you have always felt this type of passion towards this person, because being a little bit, how should I say, having some challenges in your relationship can often indicate that there is a lot of passion in the relationship, because the opposite of love isn't hate, right? It's indifference. So when you have these feelings of walking away, of just feeling annoyed with your partner or your love life, it actually shows that there is care and passion there. Of course, you want to keep these feelings as minimal as possible, because we're not about promoting toxic relationships on this channel, but you get what I mean, my beautiful Scorpios. Sometimes feeling very strongly about your partner or some of their decisions is actually an indication of you caring a lot about them. But just try to find a way to healthily channel those feelings and emotions rather than feeling the need to control or to force a situation. Because as a Scorpio, you can sometimes get a little bit jealous. Okay, now you may not want to admit that, but we're just being real here. So it's important for you to learn how to speak up when you're not feeling something, when you feel as though your partner is taking something too far, and to be very honest about how that makes you feel in general, so they can also understand where you're coming from. So all of my beautiful Scorpio babies, this is your love story prediction that I received for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section. Thank you for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Sagittarius babies, and welcome to the second and even more highly personalized part of your love story prediction. Let's get straight into it so we can figure out all of the little details about your love story. So, let's see, we've got the desert, we've got fire, and what else do we have? Dawn. Okay, so your love story is starting off with some new beginnings. So however your love story or your romantic life has been up until this point, my beautiful Sagittarius babies, it's going to completely change and it's going to do a 180. But I see here within the desert that you've most likely already kind of scoped out how you want your love life to be. You maybe have made some sort of visualization board, some sort of manifestation board. Maybe you've journaled how you wish your love life really was. And I see here within Dawn that that new beginning is taking place sooner than you expected. Within Fire, we've not only got the notion of passion, but it also immediately connects to all my Sagittarius babies, as you are a fire sign who is optimistic, you're very philosophical, honest, and straightforward. So not only being passionate, but also very real is an important part of your love story. The Hierophant shows me that you're able to connect on a deeper level with your person when it comes to spirituality, religion, and just overall the belief of something existing that is bigger and higher than all of us. And the Three of Pentacles, it does also show me here that you bring that into your work, you bring that into your professional life. So whenever you do something professionally speaking, you put your best foot forward, your partner loves that about you, and within your love story, you do the same when you try to do something or implement a change in your romantic relationship. You do so with the best intentions and with collaboration in mind. You're the type of person and sign that tries to avoid conflict at all costs. So you're not going to be in a toxic relationship where arguing is something that happens very often. You would rather channel that energy into the bedroom, into some more passionate ventures, if you know what I mean. Next up, we've got the Nine of Cups, and the Nine of Cups is actually probably the most favorable minor arcana card of a tarot deck. The Nine of Cups is known as the wish card. This card indicates that if you wish for something, it will come true almost miraculously. But we did mention this with manifestation and the desert and dawn and how you've got a new beginning coming towards you. So any type of manifestation or journaling that you've done about your love life is most likely going to come true, even if you did not expect it whatsoever. So think to yourself, putting on your visualization board or writing in your journal that you wish you would meet someone who was exactly 5 years older than you, who was 1 foot taller or shorter than you, who came from a loving family, does the work emotionally speaking, goes to therapy, and you have all of these little details, right? These are just examples, but you get the picture, my beautiful Sagittarius babies, and that person actually shows up. It seems like a miracle, but know here within the Nine of Cups that all of these little details are going to be fulfilled within your romantic life on your love story journey. Next up, we've got the North Node. So in the North Node, know that you're destined to have, you're destined to be able to experience this love of your dreams, this love story that other people would think is something that belongs in a movie, but for you, it's actually your reality. In your 10th house, I can see here that the reason why you're able to experience this is because you have this discipline of sticking to your guns, of not being afraid to say what it is that you desire. As already mentioned, you're very honest as well as good humored, but at the same time, you also kind of like expect the best for yourself and for other people. You expect the best from others. And I see here that you're meant to be with someone where the relationship has structure and you're both able to follow your life's missions. And part of your life's mission is definitely to touch other people's lives and collaborate with them. I see that here in the Three of Pentacles. So you're given a really awesome love life with someone who gets you, who understands you. Next up, we've got Aquarius as well as Square. So we know what type of important sign that your person has within their birth chart, right? We just had Aquarius, but I can also see here within Square that there is a little bit of a challenging situation here with this Aquarius person. Now, you both most likely have a lot of phallic masculine energy to offer, and you're both very driven. So I can see here within the Square that this mountain that you have to climb in your love story is one of understanding that it's okay to sometimes lean back and let your partner be in the driver's seat. Let your person show their originality, and they're a very progressive type of person, so never be afraid that they won't be able to make you proud in a situation where they're representing the two of you. Whether that be at a party, a family gathering, know here that your person, your Aquarius lover, is going to make you proud, and they're going to make you feel as though you really lucked out with this relationship. Next up, we've got the letters R as well as O. See those as indications for this person's name and just important factors within their initials. But let's move a little further into your reading. We've got the spring equinox as well as the Milky Way. So I can see here that your love story is going to cause a complete rebirth and change in perspective about how you see love and relationships. So your relationship and your love life is going to be very different, unique, and eclectic. That is why you're even able to see things from a different perspective, as we have here within the Milky Way. And a big part of seeing things from a different perspective is, of course, also a personal rebirth, a big personal change when it comes to your thought patterns. But you are a sign that is, as mentioned, very optimistic, and you're an intellectual person, so it's not hard for you to be able to put your ego aside and say to yourself, you know what, maybe what I believed up until this point wasn't completely right, or maybe it was right for this phase of my life, but now moving forward, I want to see things from a different perspective. I want to be more open-minded and just allow for myself to see another person's viewpoint like I've never done in the past. The kite shows me that it's almost like going on a vacation, right? When you're not so attached to your own thoughts and beliefs, then that allows for you to be not only open-minded, but also really relaxed. It's like, it doesn't really matter whether you end up being right or wrong. At the end of the day, you're just here to learn and enjoy the ride. Furthermore, the kite is also an indication of your love story playing out on a vacation. So meeting this person during a time where you're not working, you're off of work, and it feels like a vacation, but it could also be like a work trip. My beautiful Sagittarius babies, don't underestimate the power, the romantic powers of work trips, and just feeling like things are a little bit more relaxed. Your love story is going to have some moments of indecisiveness and feeling like you're not 100% sure if you're ready to settle down, if your love story is playing out the way that you want it to. But know here within the horseshoe that overall your love story is filled with good luck. It's filled with great fortune of meeting the right person sooner in your lifetime rather than later, experiencing new beginnings that continue to fill you with passion and allow you to be your Sagittarius self, so to say, and overall you being able to express yourself freely, which is exactly what you need. Look out for your beautiful Aquarius babies, as they're the type of person with whom you can be in a love story with, that offers you the things that you desire and need and thrive with. So be very open-minded towards people who have a lot of strong Aquarius placements within their birth chart. So all of my beautiful Sagittarius babies, this is the reading that I received for you. I hope you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Make sure you leave a little planet emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you were here, that you received this second and even more personalized part of your prediction. Thank you for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming readings. Hello, all my beautiful Capricorn babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story prediction. I hope that you enjoyed part one, but now let's add on to all the details we received during part one of your love story prediction. Let's figure out what's coming towards you as a Capricorn baby specifically. So we've got the Lotus flower, the wind, as well as the green man. I can see here within the lotus flower and the wind that things are going to unfold very quickly, and you're going to experience a type of whirlwind romance with your person. I can see that your love story is meant to play out in a very dynamic way, and once it's activated, once things begin to unfold, they just work so well in an interconnected way. As I see here within the green man, we've got this notion of synergy, okay? One hand washes another, so to say. You're meant to be with someone where you can thrive off of one another's openness and ability to be kind and caring towards one another. And I see here within the spring equinox that your love story is going to feel like a complete revamp of your love life, of your romantic experiences. You have never experienced something like this prior to this love story in particular unfolding in your existence, my beautiful Capricorns, and it's going to be not only refreshing, but kind of give you a lot of hope when it comes to love and finding someone who really does care. Because as a Capricorn, you can feel a little pessimistic at times. Now, I know this isn't easy to admit, but yes, Capricorn babies, you are very patient, careful, and reserved, and you're like that for good reason, because people have shown you their dark sides quite a few times, and it has caused a wake-up call. But I can see a different wake-up call here for you with your love story, not one where you have this rude awakening of understanding that people maybe just can't be trusted the way that you would like them to be able to be trusted, whether that be with secrets, finances, or just overall important things. But here within the tsunami, I can see a wake-up call where you're waking up to the fact that there are still some people who appreciate you for who you are, who want to put their best foot forward in a relationship, and who want to be honest, who want to be straightforward, who want to slowly unfold who they are, open up their innermost thoughts and feelings to you, as we have here within the lotus flower. These people still do exist, but you kind of have to find them, right? And when you do find the person who is perfect for your love story, you'll never want to look back ever again. Next up, we've got the Eight of Cups. So while you'll never want to look back with the right person ever again, the Eight of Cups shows me here that you're not afraid to walk away from situationships that are playing out within your love story that are not really meant to be in the long run. So if you're dating someone casually, but you're not really getting what you need from them emotionally speaking, and you feel as though the right person is all of a sudden coming along into your life, you won't really think about it twice. You will leave that situationship on the curb, on the side of the road, and move on, because you've got something better. And that definitely does show how kind of badass Capricorn babies are and how practical you are. Like, if something isn't working out for you, you don't want anyone to take it personally, but you're going to move on and have a fresh start. I see here within the Ace of Pentacles that part of your love story will also entail a fresh start financially speaking and in your career. So switching jobs and letting go of a job that didn't work out for you is part of your prediction and part of how your love life is playing out for you. And being in this moment of not quite knowing where your career is going next, but understanding here that it's something you just need to do. As I see in the Knight of Pentacles, that you're unafraid to take some steps forward when it comes to your career, even if that means that you have to leave a place that you thought you were meant to stay in. It could be a firm, it could be just some sort of business where at one point you were like, yeah, this is for me, but then you had to realize, actually, this is just not the dynamic that I need within my existence. And sometimes walking away needs to come after a couple of years, right? Some situations and jobs and people are meant to be in our life for a certain amount of time, and once their lessons have been learned and once we have had the experiences that those people and places were supposed to provide for us, we are then able to move forward taking those lessons with us. So we've got the ninth house as well as fixed. So in the ninth house, I want you to know here that your love story is going to entail a lot of spiritual growth, and it actually brings you stability too. We have a few signs here that are in the fixed realm. So we've got Taurus, Aquarius, for example. And I want you to know here that you're meant to be with someone who provides you stability, persistence, loyalty, and dependability. If those factors are not here, then you've got nothing with this person, so to say. We also had the Ace of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles, which are cards that belong to the element of Earth, because Pentacles represent just that. So I do want you to know here that we've got Taurus as that fixed sign that helps you grow immensely within the ninth house. And Taurus overall is the type of sign that you really vibe with when it comes to a love story that is meant to last for a long time. Let's see if we can find some initials for their name, some different letters. So we've got the letters T as well as O for you. But I do want to move into a little more detail, my beautiful Capricorn babies, just so we can really get the most out of your reading and figure out as much as possible about your love story. We've got the Turkey. So someone will be behaving stupidly, but this is just like a little side story to your actual love story that plays out with someone who is dependable, who is very loyal and stable. But as we had here in the Eight of Cups, and I described to you, you're going to walk away from situationships where you're not taken seriously and where someone is behaving stupidly. That's what we have here with the Turkey. In the Empty Chair, don't be surprised if there are some people who leave your life along your love story journey, which actually speaks to the fact that your love story is going to play out over many, many years. And I can see here within the nest that you have an emotionally secure, loving family, which is important to you. And having that here with the fixed signs definitely shows me that your love story is going to entail family, relationships that you can count on, and anything that's kind of rocky or patchy or crumbly, if you will, those relationships will leave your life sooner rather than later. But you have many new ones that are being formed here that are emotionally secure and loving families surrounding you. So loving families being your own family that you're creating along your love life journey, but also potentially a very loving family coming towards you from a romantic partner, from a person with whom your love life is going to play out with. Next up, we've got the Fool. So in the Fool, I can see here that this is a completely new experience. It is a 180 to what you've had up until this point, and the Chariot speaks of quick movement. So we spoke about that within the Lotus Flower and the Wind, that things are going to happen very quickly. It's going to first feel like a whirlwind romance that may not last super long, but know that your love story is actually one that feels very quick because you're constantly experiencing new things, romantically speaking, but it is meant to be that way. You are meant to experience a love story that is witty, that is fun, that is versatile, and that pushes you out of your comfort zone. So don't feel as though just because things are happening quickly that they're not meant to be or anything like that. So all of my beautiful Capricorn babies, this is the second part to your love story prediction that I have for you. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you found it insightful. Let me know below by leaving a egg emoji in the comment section for me and others to understand that you're a Capricorn baby and you made it to this part of your reading. Thank you for being here and for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll speak to you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Aquarius babies, and welcome to the second and even more personalized part of your love story reading. So let's move straight into it so you can lean back, relax, and continue to enjoy your prediction. I hope that you enjoyed part one. So we've got the Hierophant, the Chariot, the Princess of Swords, as well as the Moon. So I can see here within the Hierophant and the Chariot that you're very quickly going to click with the right person on a spiritual and very deep level, to the point where you don't even necessarily need words in order to communicate with one another. I actually see that words are going to come very quickly, so you're going to find a way to communicate effectively with your person very quickly, but at the same time, it's not going to happen right from the start. What is going to click right from the start in your love story is that deep understanding, that deep knowing, where you don't need to be talking to one another to know that the other person is feeling happy or feeling calm and just enjoying one another's company. I see here within the Moon that your relationship is a very intuitive one, where again, you're learning each other's languages. Maybe you're actually learning one another's languages quite literally because you don't speak the same first languages. So you're going to have to be dynamic and inventive and creative when it comes to communication by using words, but energetically speaking, your love story is playing out beautifully. And when you get the other person without even using or needing words, that's when you know it's really meant to be and it's really deep. And as an Aquarius baby, you are very innovative anyways. You're very friendly and you have a humanitarian side to you. So this love story reading is already starting off on such a high note because these are all the things that you thrive at and that people love you for. So let's move further into your reading. We've got the winter solstice. So in winter solstice, I can see a lot of time for reflection during your love story. So you're not going to be with a clingy person. You're not going to be with someone who constantly just wants to be breathing down your neck and doing everything with you. You're going to have a good deal of alone time as well, maybe also due to your professional life and your job. And I do want you to know here within the fog that you will still have areas of your life that are just yours, be it your art, your creativity, maybe your innermost feelings and thoughts that you don't necessarily want to run out and share immediately. Know here, my beautiful Aquarius babies, that that is okay, and you're not going to have to show every part of yourself that you don't want to embrace just yet. And that is something that I feel like is so underrated, that people don't talk about very much, but being open takes strength and it takes time and trust, and you have to want to share in order for it to be healthy. Otherwise, you're just being pushed to do something that you're not quite prepared or ready to do yet. And I want you to know here in the Princess of Swords that this definitely represents an air sign such as yourself that needs time in order to feel comfortable in their own skin, that needs time and an understanding romantic partner and situation in order to feel comfortable enough to find a way to express their emotions. So we've got Yin, House 1, as well as Pluto. So I want you to know here within Yin that we've got this very feminine energy of water and earth signs, which is all about your intuition, trust, patience, spirituality, and receptivity. So that's an important part of your love story, even though as an Aquarius, you are a masculine sign. You have this phallic energy that is constantly with you. So part of your love story is definitely very strong influences by a feminine sign. Then in the first house, we've got individuality, your self-image and approach to life, which plays an important role in your love story, as well as transforming that, not being too fixed when it comes to your approach to life. Flexibility and being able to adapt. This is a big part of your personal love story. And we've got Taurus. Taurus is just what we were talking about. It is a feminine sign. It is a sign that is very trusting and patient and also very sensual. So the type of person with whom you will have an amazing love life, who can also give you the space that you need and at the same time has this feminine energy of patience, of receptivity and openness and being able to simply meet you where you're at. And I want you to know here that this is a beautiful way for your love story to play out, being with someone who is an ideal partner for you and who balances out parts of you that maybe could benefit from another type of person and energy being present. So here we've got some letters to their name, some of their initials for you. I'll put that right here on the Taurus card, just as a little extra piece of information for you to understand exactly who this person is. Next up, we've got prayer, as well as buried in earth. So I can see here within buried in earth that you have this cosmic connection during your love story with your person, that even if you're no longer within this physical realm and body, you're still interconnected. So if you believe in an afterlife, know that this is how your love life, your love story is going to continue with your Taurus partner. It's going to continue into the afterlife. So don't you worry about things ever ending in the earthly realm, as there is so much more for you two to explore with one another, because you are true soulmates. And within prayer, I can see that the things that you pray and hope for are things that are actually destined to be yours anyways, my beautiful Aquarius babies. You can sometimes be a little unpredictable or feel like the need to detach from certain emotions because you don't want to get hurt. I mean, who does want to get hurt, right, my beautiful Aquarius babies? But do know here that when you express your emotions a little more, when you allow for yourself to put fear aside and remind yourself that fear is just a feeling, it doesn't actually have to affect you, you will find that being fearless is like therapy. It feels like being reborn and like it gives you a completely fresh perspective of being able to go on what feels like a vacation, like you can finally enjoy life because you're not overthinking things. You're not worried about what's going to happen next. And you don't feel like you're being forced to hide any of your emotions. Next, we've got the Stork. News of a birth or a new business opportunity. Well, my beautiful Aquarius babies, it seems as though your love story entails children, some sort of birth of a business opportunity, something big that will take up a lot of your time and your attention. So take that however you will, my beautiful Aquarius babies, but don't say I didn't tell you that we definitely have some sort of expansion when it comes to your family situation or just overall your workload, where you're investing a lot of time caring and nurturing something that you love and care for deeply. And this is part of your love story with your Taurus person. So I hope that you enjoyed this reading and that you found it insightful. Let me know down below in the comment section if you did. Feel free to leave a little kite emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you are in fact an Aquarius baby and you are here to receive your reading. Thank you so much for spending this divine time and space with me, and I'll catch you during one of my upcoming predictions. Hello, all my beautiful Pisces babies, and welcome to your love story prediction, part 2. I hope that you enjoyed the first part of your reading, picking from those 4 groups which I introduced you to during the intro of the video, but now let's move into even more nitty-gritty little details about your love story. So we've got the lake, we've got love, as well as Gaia, Okay, my beautiful Pisces babies, we already know here within love that we've got a great deal of compassion and pure, real love within your love story. Now, who doesn't like to hear that their love story is going to play out in this way? I see a lot of nurturing energy here alongside love. I see within Gaia that we have very caring souls that are surrounding you. We've got very loving relationships within your love story reading. So not just romantic ones, but also platonic ones. Think friends, family, colleagues, just people with whom you can share moments of stillness and it never feels awkward. It never feels off. Furthermore, I do want you to also know here within the Lake Love as well as Gaia that your love story is actually going to flow in a very effortless type of way. Your love story isn't going to be filled with toxicity, any type of negativity, or anything that is difficult to overcome. Your love story is actually one of the simpler ones. It is one of the more peaceful ones, more compassionate ones. So you having peace of mind when it comes to your love story and being in drama-free relationships allows for you to have the capacity to give a lot more than any of the other signs. So the Six of Bottles shows me that you're destined to be a giver, a nurturer, a carer within your relationships because you're able to care for yourself, and caring, loving energy is something that you're receiving as well within your love life. So that really helps you out because resentment is usually a reflection of when you don't give yourself something that you needed, right? When you resent other people for all of the time or energy that they're taking up in your life, it usually just reflects the fact that you haven't been nurturing and caring for yourself. So now you're resentful if someone else wants that from you. But I can see some great balance here when it comes to your love story. When we speak of nurturing, when we speak of care, so you're able to give a lot because you also get a lot and receive a lot. The Ten of Knives shows me that really you're just moving on from any type of a dramatic situation or person from playing games. You are not okay with a relationship where you're being lied to. As a Pisces, you're a very sensitive, kind, caring soul. You're very selfless and you need the same type of energy around you. So you being very vague with people who are not that, right? With people who are jealous or try to get under your skin is the best thing you can do because that way they don't know what's really going on within you. Therefore, they don't know your weaknesses. The Fool here shows me that you're starting a completely new love story journey during this year or the time of you watching this video, my beautiful Pisces babies. So get ready for this new updated love story of yours and for your romantic life to change. The Eight of Knives shows me here that it is about time that that happens because you have been backstabbed one too many times. As a very caring, compassionate, and selfless Pisces, I am not entirely surprised about this because compared to the other signs, you are one of those signs that just has so many natural empaths within your community. You have so many people who give a lot more than they receive. Reciprocity is often an issue within relationships with Pisces. So you moving on, this is the healthiest, best thing that could ever have happened to you. Cutting off people who are backstabbers or who simply want to exploit your weaknesses. I see here within Mercury that you have a very interesting placement with Mercury in your birth chart. And that is actually like your savior. That's what's really helping you because it allows you to think, learn, network, and communicate in an innovative way. And it allows you to adjust your love story to your needs. So being able to learn very quickly and on your feet and make adjustments immediately, it is a lifesaver for you. And I see here within Fire as well as Aries that the ideal person with whom your love story is going to play out with is a fire sign, as we have here. And guess what, Aries? That is a fire sign for you, my beautiful Pisces. We'll get into more details about them. Let's first add some letters to their name. So we've got I as well as U. I'll put that right here on your little Aries card. So Who is this person? Let's get into more detail. They are very confident as well as optimistic. They are the type of person who is passionate and brave. So they bring a lot of masculine energy to the table, which you can sometimes lack. And I see here within Aries, they're independent. They are passionate, brave, like we spoke about here within fire, and they are also an initiator. Okay, they are the type of sign who likes to be first with things, who likes to innovate. They are also the first sign of the zodiac, and they are also a cardinal zodiac sign, which means just that. So they're the one who spearheads things in the relationship, they're the one who puts themselves out there, and they're the type of person who will never be afraid to put themselves out there or put an idea out there on your behalf or in order to protect you and make sure that you feel secure and taken care of. So this is the type of person with whom your love story will play out with. I can see here within the Eight of Pentacles that your love story is a work in progress, and you will need to spend a lot of time figuring out how to work with your partner, how to deal with them, how to ensure that the relationship stays in a healthy place, learning one another's love languages. But I can definitely see here that this is a relationship that will bring you a lot of joy and teach you a lot about yourself. So your love story is really one that you will find brings a lot of positive aspects to your existence. And I see here in the Knight of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles that it will most likely also jumpstart your ventures when it comes to being independent, financially speaking, being your own boss. Your Aries person is going to give you the confidence that you need to start your own business ventures, or even just found your own company, start your own YouTube channel, and continue to stay on it, right? Because being disciplined and being consistent, those are some of the most important things you can do when you've got your own business. And I can see here with the Teapot that they're also helping you in your deep friendships with someone of the same sex and encouraging you to be around people with whom you have very deep friendships. So while this person loves you dearly and wants to be with you a lot of the time, they also know how to give you your space, and they also know of the importance of you having friendships where you can vent to people, where you can speak to others, and just overall have that exchange outside of the relationship. I see here within the Wall that your love story will start with a funny misunderstanding. So think to yourself going to a shop, for example, and accidentally while shopping pushing someone else's cart at the grocery store instead of your own, and that's how you'll meet your person, through a funny misunderstanding where you're like, hey, oh, I'm so sorry for taking your cart instead of mine. Another type of misunderstanding that we have here with the Teapot is also a misunderstanding that has to do with a friend of yours being there. So think to yourself of being at a bar or a party and you think that you're actually tapping like your friend on the shoulder, or you think that you're going to seek out your friend, but actually you bump into this Aries person, into this person with whom your love story is meant to play out with. So it's going to be a very comedic start to your love story or your relationship with this person with whom you're meant to be with. I can see here within the Vine that it's also really important for you to continue to learn about yourself, because that will help you and your romantic ventures and your relationships, my beautiful Pisces babies. And I can see here in the Torch that it will of course also help you on your spiritual development route, your road to enlightenment, more awareness and understanding of yourself, and just overall the cosmos. I mean, will we ever fully understand the divine ourselves and everything that goes on within the universe or this planet? Probably not. But the more we can kind of piece things together and understand different laws of nature, the more we can use them to our advantage and also to enjoy our love stories. So my beautiful Pisces babies, if you've made it to this point, please leave a little star emoji down below in the comment section to let me and others know that you were here in order to receive your love story prediction. So let's just quickly wrap it up one more time, shall we? I can definitely see here that your person is super compassionate and nurturing, and so are you. And you're able to give one another the alone time that you need. I want you to know here within the Ten of Knives and the Eight of Knives that you're done with backstabbers or people who seem to be your friends but aren't really, and you're letting go of those and kind of replacing them simultaneously with your Aries person. We had the Fire card show up first. We also had Mercury show up and then Aries, which makes it so eminently clear that your person has an Aries placement in either their sun sign or their rising sign in one of their most important, maybe their big three, you know, their sun, moon, and rising sign. They've got some Aries energy there, and we've got the letters I as well as you when it comes to important letters within their name. You're going to grow with one another when it comes to your career. We've got a lot of earthly energy here, okay? Out of all of the cards that I pulled from the Pastel Journey tarot deck, we've got only pentacles, the Six of Pentacles, the Eight of Pentacles, the Knight of Pentacles, and the Ace of Pentacles. Now, the Suit of Pentacles corresponds to the element of earth. And the element of earth means everything that has to do with your health, everything that has to do with your career, also your time management and how you spend things in the earthly plane. A lot of finite resources are tied up here. And I can see that you're definitely growing and a lot of change is going to take place as soon as you meet your lover here with whom your love story is meant to play out with. I can see that you will meet them through a funny misunderstanding as mentioned here within the wall, and the teapot shows me that your friends are going to be very supportive of the relationship. So ultimately this love story and how it will play out is going to lead to your spiritual development, enlightenment, awareness, and a deeper understanding, which shows that this is a very healthy situation for you to be in. So all my beautiful Pisces babies, this is your love story prediction. I hope that you enjoyed this two-part reading, that you found it insightful, fun, and kind of soothing and relaxing, healing as well. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you and I'm sending you so much love, and I can't wait to catch up with you during one of my upcoming predictions.